We're going to send you south to the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic, live third round coverage. It's a long 3-day weekend, a great weekend of sports. Sit back and relax. You got the best seat in the house. We begin with the NBA here on CBS.
With a wave from his magical wand, Isaiah Thomas led the Detroit Pistons to their first appearance in the NBA Eastern Finals. With spirits soaring, Detroit moved on to Boston to confront the battered defending champions. The Celtics appeared vulnerable, and Detroit was primed to move in for the kill. But those rumors of Boston's demise were grossly exaggerated. After two games in this series, the Celtics have performed like a team neither ready nor willing to relinquish their crown. They have pitched a shutout against Detroit so far, and now the Pistons return home for what they hope will not be their last at-bat. It's been Boston's party so far, but today the scene shifts to Pontiac, where the Pistons are brewing up party plans of their own. It's game three of the NBA Eastern Finals. And more than 20,000 fans are expected today in the Pontiac Silverdome as CBS Sports welcomes you to its coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs. Today, game three of the Eastern Conference Final between the Boston Celtics and the Detroit Pistons. The Celtics won the first two games at Boston Garden, and no Celtic team has ever lost a series after winning the first two games of any series. Hello again, everyone. I'm Dick Stockton, and welcome to the NBA on CBS. And you really now have to marvel at what the Boston Celtics have achieved. They went through the regular season basically with a five-man team. They have lost at one time or another three of their five starters in the playoffs, and they still roll on, and right now they are in the driver's seat. My partner is Tommy Heinsohn. Tommy, I think right now the Celtics may have gotten their second wind, and maybe the worst is over for them. Who knows?
They may well be, Dick, that they've gotten their second win. I think right now the Pistons missed a golden opportunity. Bird has assumed the offensive leadership of this team. It's taken a lot of pressure off McHale and Parrish to produce point-wise.
Now, the Detroit Pistons lost the first two games. You talk about how they missed a great chance to win game one when the Celtics were a bit tired. They have not really played well in this series.
I don't think they've paced the game the way they have to pace to try and tie the Celtics out. Isaiah Thomas is the key. He has got to be not only a point producer, but a creator of offense for others. That's a real challenge for an emotional ball player.
All right, this is really the game for the Pistons. If they're down 3-0 to Boston, you can virtually forget about it. So the season for the Pistons rides on today's game. Coming up, game three, it's the NBA on CBS.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by Miller Genuine Draft Cold Filtered Draft Beer. It's as real as it gets. Renault and Jeep, official vehicles of the NBA. And by ShopVac's Litter Critter, the manual push sweeper that cleans driveways, patios, and other outdoor surfaces.
It's real. I know it's real.
There was a time when there was only one kind of beer. Rich, smooth draft beer. It wasn't pasteurized or tampered with. It was just real beer. Miller Genuine Draft is as real as that. It's not heat pasteurized like most other beers. It's cold filtered, so it's as rich and smooth as only real draft beer can be. Miller Genuine Draft.
It's as real as it gets.
Personally, I've always admired his use of yellow.
His merging of abstract shapes and a multi-hued palette is one of the joys of our time.
Yes, his subtle shading, his sensitivity to the gray spectrum.
The stroke work of a Rembrandt.
Oh, it's so thrilling to see the new IBM Personal System 2 in the hands of an old master.
Balderdash.
The new IBM Personal System 2, advancing the art of business.
There's something new on the road. It's built by Jeep.
It's the kind of truck only Jeep could build, but it's also the kind of truck just about anybody can afford. The new short bed Jeep Comanche Sport Truck. It's worth a look.
Get low financing or cash back on Comanche. Excludes truck shown and other two-wheel drive short beds.
You could buy a $100,000 sweeper to clean up around your house.
Hey, look out, Marge!
I'm coming through! Sure, it cleans driveways and patios quickly and easily, but so does the Litter Critter from ShopVac. A revolutionary new way to clean dirt and debris from outdoor surfaces without electricity or batteries. And when you're finished, the Litter Critter stays out of your way.
You didn't buy that, Herbert!
I'm not crazy! I leased it!
The Litter Critter, a sweeping improvement from ShopVac.
Here at the Pontiac Silverdome, the starting lineups, and for the Boston Celtics, Jerry Seasting will start the third straight game in place of Danny Ainge, who still can't move laterally and remains on the bench. Casey Jones, the head coach of this outstanding team. For the Detroit Pistons, Dantley, Mahorn, Laimbeer, Thomas, and Dumars. In the backcourt, Thomas the key man, of course, and Chuck Daly, the winningest coach in Piston history. Kevin McHale is feeling better, but Robert Parrish aggravated his injured ankle in game two. It is sore, and Dr. Tom Silva said he could not have played if game three had been yesterday, and so he'll be the man to watch. And Tommy, also a matchup change for the Pistons regarding Parrish.
Potentially, they're going to use Ricky Mahorn to guard Robert Parrish, to body up against Parrish, keep him off the boards. Laimbeer was not successful in handling Parrish's jump shot in games one and two.
Darryl Garrettson and Hugh Hollins are the officials. Ed Middleton is at the scorer's table as the alternate today. And there is Parrish, who is having a tremendous series nonetheless, and the only man that the Celtics could not really afford to lose. They managed to win without Ainge. They've won without McHale. Even during the year, they won without Bird. But without Robert Parrish, they lost to Milwaukee in game six. Celtics in green, Pistons in white. We're underway, Detroit ball. You talked about the backcourt. What about the frontcourt for this team?
Well, Isaiah has to get them involved just like that, to the Mahorns, the Laimbeers, and Adrian Dantley also. They've got to get points from their inside people.
Dantley is their inside guy. Puts the shot up, and the Celtics. Now, Dantley is listed at 6'5", really 6'3", and so he's at a disadvantage up front.
The real challenge for Boston is to control that offensive board so that Detroit cannot get fast break opportunities.
Larry Bird has been in a shooting slump, under 40%, hits the first bucket of the game.
He's been their prime offensive player in the prior two games.
Mostly as a passer and a rebounder. He did score 31, but his shooting hasn't been up to par. Parrish the rebound on Mahorn's miss.
Well, it looks like the Pistons already are trying to get those big guys involved.
First two shots taken by the front court. Seasting guarded by Thomas, who gets the ball away from Jerry. Two on one. Dumars. And the Pistons are on the board. I think Thomas was frustrated by Seasting in game number two particularly.
I think he was very anxious. He wanted to produce wins, and he got emotional and got carried away.
McHale picked up by Laimbeer. That's the other half of that matchup change for the Pistons today. But Parrish is there to get the offensive rebound. Seasting. Jerry Seasting started twice against the Pistons in the regular year and averaged 15 points, and he has really played well and within himself in this series. Yeah. Plenty of time on the clock. They double Dantley. Dumars with six now. Thomas. 3 seconds, and Isaiah Thomas takes an off-balance shot.
If they play half-court offense against the Boston Celtics and try to match them in that department, they may be very sorry about it.
Parrish travels, turns it over.
The pace game is very important for the Pistons today, to show things happening now that may produce results later on in the ball game.
There's the matchup change up front. McHale picking up Isaiah Thomas on a switch. That's why the Pistons are able to get so many offensive rebounds, because the Celtics switch. And Detroit is in position to get the ball. Thomas misses, and Detroit ice cold. They have been cold from the field in the first two games. The trail here with 2.5 minutes gone by two. Bird missed the layup. Normally, that's automatic.
Celtics now are successful in really delaying the advance of the ball, just getting over the rebounder and getting close to Isaiah so he can't receive it.
Dumars was hot early in game one and inexplicably stopped shooting in the second half.
Well, that's when Isaiah really determined that he was emotionally going to take over the game and forgot some of these other guys on his ball club.
Tied at four, a little more than 3 minutes elapsed in the first period of game three and the start of a big weekend of NBA playoff basketball on CBS. Bird over Dantley, and Larry Bird has four of the Celtics' 6 points.
They've been attacking that matchup, Bird against Dantley, almost exclusively in the first two games.
Thomas goes by Seasting, gets the basket, and draws the foul. He came back with 36 points, but only 3 free throws in the fourth quarter of game two.
Seasting really has his hands full because Isaiah is an extremely quick offensive player. Little fakes, and he can get into anybody's defense and cause immense problems.
This is the free throw, and the Pistons have been horrible. 63% from the free throw line in two games. And it remains 6-6. The foul, by the way, was on Seasting.
Celtics have been using this matchup, Bird against Dantley, to really tire out Dantley, one of the Pistons' prime offensive players.
Dennis Johnson, who has scored 18 points in each of the first two contests. Thomas draws a crowd, leaving Dumars open. And those are the kind of shots the Pistons are going to have to hit. They're basically a perimeter shooting team. McHale against Lambeer. Tried to draw the foul, and Parrish did. And now they say the foul is against Adrian Dantley.
Detroit foul number 45. Adrian Dantley, his first.
Adrian Dantley's going to have a man-sized job trying to get offensive rebounds against Larry Bird. Bird is a super blockout man, creates room for himself, and just knows how to time the rebound so nobody else can get at him.
You talked about Bird being the offensive generator, and that pick-and-roll play with Parrish really has been troublesome. There it is for the Pistons.
They have not made an adjustment on that play, and that's a play from back in the 40s and 50s. It's sort of like the Green Bay Packers sweep. Everybody knows it's coming, but if you execute it properly, nobody can stop it.
Dantley, Newey hit the jumper, and Adrian Dantley, who was the leading scorer in the regular season. He only had 3 attempts, I should say, in the fourth quarter, so the big guns in Detroit's arsenal did not get many shots in the fourth period. Bird, this is Lambeer. Outlets to Thomas. Celtics are back. Oh, what a play. Scoop shot by Thomas.
That was a classic on how to get pace and a fast break going at the same time. It all started with Lambeer's excellent outlet pass.
7 minutes to go in the first period. McHale and a 3-second violation called against the Boston Celtics. And the Detroit Pistons, who have yet to take the lead, will have that opportunity when we come back to the Silverdome with just under 7 minutes to go.
If you can dream it, you can do it. Today, the Prudential can show you a new world of financial opportunities. Look to the Rock for mutual funds, stocks, and bonds. Feel its strength in CDs, insurance, and mortgages. With the right choices, the right guidance, the sky's the limit. The Prudential, your rock in financial services.
It's real, I know it's real. No other reason for the way I feel. Oh yeah, it's as real as it gets.
The best things are the real things, and draft beer is the real beer. Miller Genuine Draft.
Oh yeah, it's as real as it gets.
Some of the year's biggest money winners take on the scenic but challenging terrain at the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic on CBS Sports next.
Well, if the Pistons are going to get back into the series, they're going to have to quicken the pace, as Tommy mentions. And here's Tom, more specifically.
Quicker pace begins with crisp outlet passes that get the Pistons moving and puts pressure on the slowest Celtics to retreat on defense. The Detroit gods must push the ball hard. Good things happen when they do. And the long-term effects of a quicker pace against the Celtics will pay off in the fourth period. But everybody has to run, not just the guards. The forwards must get out on the wings. Put pressure on the defense and finish off easy fast break opportunities. And by penetrating Boston's defense before they are set, Isaiah Thomas holds the key to defeating Boston today. The key for Detroit today, pace.
And as you mentioned, Tom, Isaiah Thomas, in setting that pace, has to really dish it off and get everyone involved, and it looked like that's what he's been trying to do early on.
He sure has, and I guess he's listened to Chuck Daly. He's quickening the pace and dishing it off.
The Pistons are looking for their first lead of this game, and Adrian Dantley gives it to him.
Bird is not a real good one-on-one defender, and the Pistons are keying on that. They're going to Dantley when they go to their half-court offense an awful lot.
McHale, good passing by the Celtics around the perimeter. Seasting misses. Lambeer, who's a brilliant defensive rebounder. Into the crowd, here's Dantley again, and the Pistons are up by four.
Dantley sure did his share of running, but again, it all started with Lambeer's crisp outlet pass.
The Pistons have scored eight in a row to take this four-point lead. Whistle blows and no basket. Illegal defense called against Detroit.
Here you're going to see Bill Lambeer's outlet pass, just like we showed you before. When he comes down, there's no delay in the outlet, and all of a sudden they're right on the attack, and Boston, not too fast, can't protect.
That's the warning, of course, on that illegal defense. Seasting coming off the screen hits.
Jerry Seasting.
Who has scored 12 and 11 in the first two games and is shooting near 50%. Really doing a terrific job in place of Danny Ainge, who's been very important to the Celtics. 14 to 12, Dantley. And Dantley is hot off to a big start with 8 points.
And that was a big shot for Dantley outside. Kevin McHale back way down off of him, daring him to shoot.
They're going to McHale exclusively, it seems. And Kevin responds with his first points of the game, so all five Celtics starters are on the board in a two-point Detroit lead. Good fake. Dantley goes around Bird and draws the foul inside, and it's on Robert Parrish, his first of the game, and for the Celtics, their third team foul.
Great play here by Adrian Dantley. Why he's so good is that, as a forward, he's an excellent dribbler. He's got that wide body to protect the ball with, and he knows how to use it. And he invariably takes it to the hoop, can score, and get fouled all at the same time.
Acquired from Utah for Kelly Trepiuka, no longer the big cheese as he was in Utah. And he's had to adjust here in Detroit. And very often, Tommy, he finds himself on the bench late in the ball game because his kind of style doesn't necessarily work then.
Well, defense is not one of his big things, although I think he's been doing a fairly decent job against Larry Bird, who's been shouldering most of the offensive load in the first two games for the Celtics.
Dantley only makes one, and they're going to call a foul against the Pistons.
Offensive basket interference against Detroit Boston ball.
Offensive basket interference is called against Detroit, and now Casey Jones wants a 20-second timeout. Detroit is up by three with 5:15 to go in the first period, and you'd have to say that the Pistons are improving the way they pace the game. What else can they do?
I think that they also have distributed the ball rather nicely, far better than they have in any of the other games, and that Isaiah is doing his job. He's got to pick his spots where to score. I think eventually what will happen is that when the players start spreading out on defense for the Celtics, Isaiah will have an easier time penetrating.
And of course that's important because the Pistons have a definite mismatch against them in the front court, and those have been the numbers after two games. In the hands of Dennis Johnson. Bird looking inside, no one there right now. Now isolated, Johnson on Dumars. Dumars, one of the best defenders.
Oh!
And a good rebound by Mahorn.
Boy, did he put a body on Parrish to block him off that offensive glass.
Inside, lean bear, basket good, and a foul. Mikhail on the foul, and Bill Lane Beer, who scored only 2 points on Thursday night.
He's doing it the right way. Isaiah looks now after he can't penetrate, waits for Lambeer to clear Mikhail, who had great position, and it was just an easy up and in, plus the foul on Mikhail. And that's an important foul. They're trying to foul the Celtics big guys out early or get the Boston bench, particularly Greg Kite.
And the Pistons have upped their lead to 6. Biggest lead for either side in this opening period with 4:35 remaining. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn, game 3, best of 7. The Celtics won the first 2 at Boston Garden. Mikhail over Lambeer.
Dick, I think they'll work that matchup because Lambeer is not a leaper and Mikhail will be able to get the shot off anytime he wants.
They've been going to Mikhail throughout this period. Danley drives in. You're looking at vintage Adrian Danley right now. He has scored 11 points and his last 5 shots. Ceasing in a crowd. And no basket. If it goes, they'll call another 3-second violation against Boston.
Ceasing had the shot. He turned it down to try and pick up the foul on Lambeer.
Lambeer, good outside shooter. Where he likes to pop from.
They are all involved, the Pistons. That's trouble for the Celtics.
Mahorn, the only starter not to score for Detroit. Bird misses. Lambeer. And there's Dantley. The Pistons are on a 20-6 run. Timeout, and they're going wild with the silver ball.
Announcing nothing in factory financing. 0%. Available on new Renault GTA and Alliance models. Or get $500 cash back. Announcing 0% factory financing on selected new Jeep Comanches. Or get up to $700 cash back. You can use the cash as a down payment. These are limited time offers, so see your Renault Jeep dealer now.
The Great American Face. Strong. Sensitive. The Great American Razor. Actra Plus. Solid. With the Lubra Smooth Strip for extra protection. The Great American Face deserves the Great American Shave. Actra Plus. Only from Gillette.
Just because you've washed your car doesn't mean you're finished. You need some Armor All. On the dash, the bumper, and especially the tires. Armor All. It's the finishing touch every time you wash your car.
These days, a lot of airlines are cutting corners on their meals.
This little beauty we like to call banquet on a bun, right, Bob?
Banquet on a bun.
I like it.
Sit down, Bob. Now, with this, you can serve a whole plain loaf for just pennies.
I like it.
Holastic parsley. You can use it over and over again.
I like it.
Pygmy chickens. You can get 125 in ordinary shoebox.
I like it.
At Alaska Airlines, we spend a little more on our meals, and you can taste the difference.
I was always afraid if I started crying, I'd never stop.
Mike Farrell, Memorial Day.
Well, here's what Isaiah Thomas had to say when asked what he has to do to get Detroit back in gear.
Well, I got to somehow get Lambeer and Mahorn and get all guys involved earlier in the game. I think what happened in the game in Boston was I was totally involved offensively, but as the game wore on, I lost track of some of the guys. I think tonight, the first half, I'll make sure the guys get involved. In the second half, I'll try to do more.
Well, he's done that, but now the Celtics have to talk about a 10-point deficit right now.
They have to break the tempo of this game. They've got to really move the ball around on their own offense and also delay the up-quick of the Pistons when they gain possession.
Steal by Thomas. Pistons started 1 of 5 from the field, but they've hit 11 of 12, including their last 7 shots. They are sizzling from the field. And Danley, with an ill-advised pass, fortunately knocked out of bounds for him by McHale. Mikhail up on Lane Beer. Doesn't want him to get that jumper off. Dumas does. Eight in a row. Eight shots in a row hit by the Pistons, who are up by 12.
Dumas is really going to be an X factor in this series before it's all over. He can also augment what Isaiah does.
He can play either guard position. And a great defender. And illegal defense against Detroit on Isaiah Thomas. And that'll be a technical foul. And Boston will shoot. Well, Mahorn is trying the old Toreador maneuver against Parrish here.
Well, lean on him, get him to lean back on you, and then step back, and you just fall on your rear end.
Bird makes the free throw. We saw in our game in March here, when Detroit won, that Mahorn did the same thing to Kevin McHale to great success.
Well, he pushes so hard, you have to lean back hard.
Dennis Johnson, line drive, shot breaks the string. It's 28 to 19 now with 2:35 remaining in the first period, and Detroit getting a lot more mileage from their front line.
But Boston is experienced at taking a good first quarter shot from teams. They're perfectly capable of coming back.
As long as Detroit's not doing this on emotion, because right. Emotion runs out.
Right.
Bird. And Larry Bird now with 7 points. He leads the Celtics scores. Danley has 13 to top Detroit. Winding down to 2 minutes to go, first period. Dumas loses it out of bounds, a little too anxious.
And they're distributing the ball in a very intelligent manner. They're looking for the best matchup. That time they try to go to Dumas in the low post against Seasting.
And Vinny Johnson, microwave, they call him because he heats up so fast, replaces Dumas. And there's a man who personifies the term streak shooter.
Looks like a fire plug with legs.
And Sam Vincent, who played his college ball at Michigan State and played pretty well in this series, is in the game as well. McHale is fouled and will go to the line to shoot two. So two guards in the game, Vinny Johnson and Sam Vincent for Boston.
First in the last 2 minutes.
Foul is on Isaiah Thomas, his first foul and the fourth team foul against Detroit. There's Vincent, who at 10 quality minutes hit all of four free throws and really did a good job on Isaiah Thomas, stripped him of the ball late in the game.
Plays so much against Isaiah in the summer months that he knows his game perhaps better even than Jerry Seasting. But what really is important right now, Dick, is the fact that the Celtics going to McHale are trying to get Lambeer in foul trouble. He's playing soft to defense because he doesn't want to get in foul trouble, and the Celtics are trying to exploit that.
Low post, Stanley against Bird. Blocked shot. Into the hands of Bird. Here's Vincent, 3-on-1 for Boston. And McHale couldn't handle the pass, and now Detroit comes back 4-on-2. Mahorn to Thomas, and he's fouled. Push going up, and Sam Vincent. The foul, I believe, is not on Vincent. It's on Larry Bird, and that's his first. And Thomas will go to the line.
Isaiah Thomas at the line for Detroit for
Danny Ainge, who has a sprained right knee ligament. And he's day-to-day.
You know, the key to Isaiah's game is the outside shot. Once they get into the half-court set, if he hits a couple of outside shots, whoever's defending against him has to step up to him to deny that shot, and then he can turn that quickness loose on him.
Greg Kite is into the ball game, replacing Robert Parrish. And Kite had 3 rebounds in 6 minutes, plus a 3-point play. So Kite is in there. And a lot of pressure on him, I guess, if Parrish is not 100%.
He needs to really rebound, particularly on a defensive board.
1:10 to go in the first period. Bird now with 9. And it's 30-25 in favor of the Pistons, who are up by 12 in this period. So the Celtics have come back and going to their bench now.
This is always a key point for the Celtics, how well they can maintain whatever mark it is on the scoreboard before the bench comes in.
Vinny Johnson. He once hit 22 points in one quarter against the Celtics. Remember that in the playoffs? In 85.
He was more than a white microwave that day.
Sam Vincent hits the basket, which should do world of confidence for it. Sam. It's a 5-point lead for Detroit.
Vinny that day was a 5-alarm blaze.
Thomas has a shot blocked by Kite. Lane Beer comes in with the follow-up and draws the foul as well.
That is one great illustration of what penetration can do. Even though the shot is missed, everybody on the Celtics will go to the penetration, and you see Lambert just roaming around in there all by himself to get good offensive position for the rebound. That's why it's so important to keep Isaiah out of the paint.
Kite with his first foul, but the Pistons now on the bonus. And Lambert with a three-point play. He has 8 points in the game and an eight-point lead.
Boy, and look at Vinny Johnson just denied Dennis Johnson the ball. Makes Sam Vincent become the playmaker.
And the foul is on Thomas, who's really enraged. Isaiah Thomas had a run away. Otherwise, he might have gotten in a little bit of trouble. Picks up his second foul.
That is a foolish foul for a guy that's going to be so important for this ball club in the second half. He didn't need to play defense against Sam Vincent like that at this stage at the end of the quarter.
Well, a lot of that mugging and a lot of that one-upsmanship he exhibited in the second game of that series. And here is Vincent on the line. That's the 15th foul against Detroit as Dumars replaces Thomas, who has a chance now to cool off, and he needs it.
He gets so emotional in any game, but when it's a playoff game and he's never reached this level before, I would imagine he's doubly anxious and doubly emotional, and he can't get out of control.
He's on the bench with two personal fouls. One out of two for Vincent, and the Pistons can play for the last shot of this first period, leading by seven. So Dumars is in the game. Vincent has that assignment. Vinny Johnson. And the final shot. That'll do it. After one, the Pistons were down by four early, and they came on big and lead it 37-28 after one period.
Bottled beers have to take the heat of pasteurization. And this can change their real taste. But there's one kind of beer that's not heat pasteurized, draft beer. And now there's real draft beer in bottles. Miller Genuine Draft. It's not heat pasteurized. It's cold filtered, so it retains all of its rich, smooth, real taste. Miller Genuine Draft.
It's as real as it gets.
We can be.
America's game. It's fantastic.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by U.S. Sprint. We're building a 100% digital fiber optic network clear across America. And by Gatorade Thirst Quencher. Gatorade is thirsty for that deep down body thirst.
Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn, and after one period of play, it's a 9-point lead for the Pistons, who are really shooting the lights out. Not that Boston isn't shooting well. They're getting the fast break going, so they're pushing the ball up effectively, and Adrian Dantley has had a very fine first period. And conversely, for the Celtics, their leading scorer so far in the series, Robert Parrish, who's averaging over 25, has scored just 2 points in that first period. So as we start the second, Parrish comes back into the ball game for the Celtics, and he'll be in there with Kite, Bird, Johnson, and Vincent. So a couple of big towers in there for the Green.
And John Sally in for the Pistons, and that ought to be able to provide another guy that can run on that fast break. And he's lining up against Bird.
Sally's a rookie, played well during the year. But in the playoffs, Bird goes up and misses. Sally the rebound, and they're going to call offensive interference against the Boston Celtics.
Greg Kite hit the net. And as soon as you do that, it's goaltending.
Detroit with the edge in the front line. John Sally could be a key man in this game as Dantley goes up and draws the foul. Let's talk about Sally, who showed the jitters of a rookie along with Dennis Rodman in the first two games.
But he's been a very important factor all season long for this ball club. Come along nicely, has learned how to attack the boards when Isaiah penetrates. He's not much of a shooter, but he can move his feet on defense. And at times, we just saw him take Bird. That's quite an accomplishment for a big guy like him to go out there and try and play defense in the open court.
Foul is on Bird, his second personal. And Kevin McHale checks in.
Kevin McHale back into the Celtics lineup.
And Greg Kite goes out.
Replacing Greg Kite.
So now the Celtics have four of their five men who started the game, with Sam Vincent being the fifth.
Celtics always substitute around timeouts, end of quarters, to gain that extra advantage of a couple of minutes consecutive rest.
Dantley makes one. He has 14 to lead all scorers. And a 10-point lead for the Pistons. Lambeer with a good 8-point first period, waiting to get the call. And a turnover. Sally created that one. And Dantley at the other end.
Did he get out fast on the wing? Everybody's got to run to make the pace game work. He's doing it.
Pistons on an 8-1 run and have matched their biggest lead now. 12 points. McHale. Tough shot against Mahorn.
Mahorn and Lambeer have tried to contain McHale. They forced him to the fall away more than that power move to the hoop.
Dantley working against Bird again and hitting again. 18 for AD.
Maybe AD found Vinny's microwave.
He's 8 for 10 from the field. Bird doubled. Dennis Johnson. Boy, Dennis Johnson will make the toughest shots a guard can make.
Boy, he is so intelligent a player. He takes those tough shots at just the right time to help destroy the morality of the other team.
Lead is 10. First 2 minutes of this second period. Five on the shot clock.
Kalon Dantley. Celtics trying to disturb Dantley's rhythm a little bit with McHale.
They did there. They love him to shoot from outside all day. Sally defending McHale.
Boy, and Mahorn just doing an outstanding job keeping Parrish off the glass.
Vinny Johnson. McHale gets it, and Dennis Johnson. Picked up by Sally on a switch, and an offensive foul called against Robert Parrish, and that'll be two on Parrish.
Here's Sally keeping McHale off the boards, and McHale knows how to rebound very effectively, but you watch what Sally does. Well, it's Mahorn keeping Parrish off the board.
Well, that's the matchup the Pistons went to today.
You like your one and only body like you never have before.
Nothing cuts through thirst like Gatorade Thirst Quencher. It speeds in fluids and minerals and supplies energy to working muscles.
Quench it! Gatorade is thirsty for that deep down body thirst.
Once and for all, who gives you the best savings in long distance nationwide?
U.S. Sprint, may I help you?
That's right, U.S. Sprint. You can save as much as 10, 20, even 30% versus AT&T on your long-distance calls.
Yes, that's right.
And you'll be signing up with the company that's building the first and only 100% digital fiber optic network clear across America. Now, how do you start getting the best overall savings? Well, you've got to call.
U.S. Sprint, may I help you?
Who builds the best family wagons in America? 200 owners of Ford and GM cars compared Dodge Caravan and Plymouth Voyager with new V6 power to Ford Aerostar and Chevy Astro. After judging 45 important features, they rated Chrysler's front-wheel drive family wagons best. 79% chose Voyager and Caravan over Astro, 84% chose them over Aerostar. And only Chrysler's family wagons get a new 770 protection plan. End of test.
In 18 years, nobody's managed to repeat. That was then. These are the Celtics. The playoffs continue tomorrow on CBS Sports.
Well, following the game, you'll see the third round of the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic, and Davis Love the third with a course record after two rounds, has a three-stroke lead over four others, and that'll follow our action later today. Tommy, in the first two games, the Detroit Pistons were the jittery team making the mistakes. The Celtics are not so jittery so much today, but they have committed turnovers, and the Pistons have capitalized on them.
Well, I think they threw a different defensive scheme at the Celtics, and I think the Celtics have not adjusted to it yet.
Darren Day is into the ballgame, replacing Larry Bird, who scored nine, goes to the bench with two personals. Vinny Johnson with a good screen from Sally, gets his own rebound, converts.
Vinny Johnson is a monster rebounder for a guard. You've got to put a body on him.
So Darren Day, who had his biggest moment against the Milwaukee Bucks in game four. And really, the Celtic bench has made contributions. In the playoffs, Sam Vincent hits his second jumper.
Sam Vincent.
And the score now is 44-34 with just under 9 minutes remaining in the first half. Detroit in front.
But Detroit is slowing the pace game down. Dumars is not making a hard push. That they must continue that for the full 48 minutes to really be effective against the Celtics.
Well, you're a tough taskmaster, but you're right. Dumars gets the roll.
Boston can peck away, peck away, peck away. You've got to count on at least one or two explosions against Boston in the second half.
And another illegal defense call against the Pistons, their third of the game, and a technical situation, of course. And another technical. Second technical of the game, and Chuck Daly, who's more than just pomp and pompadour, as you see with his hairstyle there.
There is a little defense and, well, illegal defense in action.
Dennis Rodman, the other good rookie who's played this year along with Sally, replaces Adrian Dantley, who goes to the bench with 18 points and a terrific first half for AD. So Rodman is in the game, and he's a cheerleader on and off the court. He threw a couple of air balls on the free throw line in game two, coming down to earth maybe in game three. Who knows?
Was he embarrassed? But they only put him in when Darren Day showed up.
And Vincent trying to get inside with push. I sense a lot more confidence in Sam Vincent since he's been used in this series.
Well, he's from this area, and he feels like he's at home. He knows Isaiah better perhaps than anybody else. And Sam would like nothing better than to come through, of course, in a game like this. And I think he's got the talent for it.
You always have, I know that. Sally commits the foul, his first.
Well, Sam is almost a duplicate of Isaiah. He can penetrate against anybody. But that has not been utilized with the Celtics because they have slow big men.
10-point lead after Vincent makes one. Winding down to 4 minutes to go. Good acceleration by Johnson. Feed to Lambeer. Celtics are claiming that the Pistons interfered with it on the cylinder. No call. And a terrific step to the hoop by Vinny Johnson.
Celtics again having trouble with penetration. They shut down Isaiah's penetration, but they haven't with Vinny.
Once again, a 12-point lead for the Pistons. Vinny Johnson steals it from Parrish. Dumars. This is a different Piston team in the first half today.
Very aggressive defense on the double teams.
Biggest lead now of 14 at 50-36. Johnson nearly has the ball stripped away by Dumars. Parrish loses it out of bounds.
Aggressive defense. Now you watch Vinny just go in there and attack. And Robert Parrish should have been able to get that over the head of Vinny Johnson. But no soap.
Johnson. And the Pistons opening it up as Larry Bird can only sit and watch. Timeout.
Legends of the NBA. The smooth touch makes it count. Sponsored by Schick.
With the game on the line, few men were tougher competitors than JoJo White. White possessed determination, coupled with a gentle touch, knowing how to exploit an opponent's weakness and then burning him for 2 points. He enjoyed taking the game's decisive shot and was rarely denied the pleasure, for JoJo White thrived on the art of winning.
Disposable has a new blade angle that's designed to give you a light touch. An easy touch that's closer than ever.
A touch that's easy makes me understand. When it comes to love, I want a slow hand.
The new Shift Disposable for the easy touch.
Coming up soon. Right now, let's check in with our man, Pat O'Brien.
All right, Dick, and look who I found in the stands. The sledgehammer, Charles Barkley. Charles, with Julius Erving gone now on the 76ers, you're the leader of the team. Are you ready to accept that role next year?
Well, I don't think it really matters if I'm ready or not. Next year will be on my shoulders, and I'm looking forward to the challenge.
You're here to support your good friend, Vinny Johnson. What do you think of this series?
Well, it's going to be a tough series. I like Detroit in this series if they can win the next two home games. But it's going to be a great series. Boston's a great team.
How many hot dogs have you had so far?
Just two so far.
Okay, let's go back to Dick.
All right, Pat, and listen to this slap. Laimbeer and McHale. Just listen to this now. This was inside. What did he do wrong to deserve a slap on the wrist?
Well, you know, inside players count on their forearms and their hands to become part of their eyes so they can know where the man is and the ball at the same time. And the offensive player does not want you to feel him. So there's a lot of slapping that goes on in there.
Larry Bird is back in the game. And Tommy, how have the Pistons been playing him so far today?
I don't think they've been double teaming him as much as they did in the prior game. He became a great passer.
And a foul against Joe Dumars, second team foul against the Pistons, and one against Dumars. And Larry Bird will go to the line.
Now Bird loves to be double teamed, Dick, because he loves to pass and create opportunities for his teammates. That's all through his college career and through his professional career he's done that. And the double teams were allowing him to do that, creating easy offense for Parrish, McHale, and others. If they change that defense, Bird will have to score points on his own, and so will the others.
But the Pistons have been able to run today, something they didn't do in the first two games. And as you pointed out, game one was their golden opportunity. And they are 14-0 in fast break points. Vinny Johnson, red hot, now with 10 points in the ball game, and it's 54-38. The Pistons with a solid lead and 6.5 remaining in the second period. Detroit shooting nearly 70% in this game. Coming in, they were under 50 at 46. So they found the range here in game three so far. Feasting wide open. McHale gets the offensive rebound. And blocked from behind by Rodman. And the Pistons are getting the loose balls in this one. Rodman off the side of the backboard.
A 4-on-2 they had, Dick, and didn't get a layup out of it.
Johnson goes around Dumars, blocked by Laimbeer. Dennis Johnson put a move on Joe Dumars, you wouldn't believe.
Here's Dennis Johnson, and Laimbeer really makes a great reaction to that drive. Gets there quick, cuts off the play, but can't hold on. Laimbeer's feet were not moving as quickly in Boston as they are here at the Silverdome.
And Bird is fouled before he can go up with a shot. And it's Dennis Rodman with his first foul and the 13th foul against Detroit.
The fast pace of his first half, plus the different defensive scheme of Detroit, I think, has really got Boston a little bit confused.
Fred Roberts was in ever so briefly, and McHale comes back in. Detroit, red hot in the first period. They're still shooting well. Rodman on Bird, Parrish. And Robert Parrish with 4 points, well below his 25 average in the series.
John Sally just did not have the beef to move Parrish out of the sweet spot in there.
So the Pistons playing with two rookies, Sally and Rodman. Vinny Johnson shuffles it into Sally. There's that penetration again for Detroit.
Well, Vinny Johnson's become a creator. What next?
And how long has Isaiah Thomas been on the bench? The Pistons are making hay, leading by 16 with their general on the sideline. Bird misses. McHale follows it up. Rodman into the hands of Vinny Johnson. 5 minutes to go in the half. Here he is again. VJ misses. And Parrish looking for McHale. It'll be Detroit ball. McHale stepped on the line. Look at.
There's McHale really being outclassed by two of the Pistons. McHale hustled for it, but his foot was on the line. He thought he was fouled, but he was out of bounds when it happened.
And the Pistons can open up their biggest lead if they score. Lambeer. And the offensive rebound again in the hands of Vinny Johnson.
Celtics ending up with matchups. Parrish guarding Dumas and feasting Vinny Johnson. That's not the way the Celtics want it.
Lambeer. Look at that bench by the Pistons. And the smile on Isaiah Thomas's face. And it's an 18-point lead, 58-40 for Detroit.
Well, a point has been proven. When the other Pistons get involved, Isaiah is not truly needed.
And a foul against Detroit. Thomas has been out for 8 minutes, and Detroit has gone to town.
You take a look at Bird and Dennis Rodman going at it, and Bird is trying to create room for himself. Rodman holding on. Bird just saying, it's a tug of war in here, kid. I know that you've got fouls to waste, but watch yourself.
Vinny Johnson committed the foul. Vinny Johnson coming off the bench has scored 10 points, has 3 rebounds and 4 assists. And that's exactly what the Pistons expect of him.
Well, Isaiah's going to get a good long rest right now so that when he comes into the second half, he can pick up this caseload that he left to Vinny Johnson.
Dumars and Vinny Johnson. And Johnson is fouled. Sally, Rodman, and Lambeer. So two rookies in the lineup as Detroit opens their lead. Fred Roberts comes in for McHale, and Roberts is in there along with Parrish, Bird, Darren Day, and Seasting. So in essence, Darren Day is playing a guard position with Jerry Seasting.
That's a good matchup advantage for Boston. Presumably his size will be able to stop Vinny Johnson, but Vinny Johnson is afraid of no 7-footer, so why should he be afraid of Darren Day?
Who committed his first foul. Team fouls, 4 against Detroit, only 2 against Boston. Game 3, best of 7. Detroit leading by 18 points over the Celtics, who won the first 2 games in Boston Garden. This is for the right to go to the NBA Finals. And the Boston Celtics are a great story, and the Pistons coming back here. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn, and the foul is on Rodman.
Little muscle going on. Rodman, the rookie, saying, I've got 6 fouls to wear Larry Bird down. Maybe they only call 3 of the 6. Maybe I can foul him 12 times before I foul out of the game and make him work hard. That's what they're trying to do.
15 fouls, so the Celtics will shoot. Rodman goes out. And Adrian Dantley with 18 back in the game, and he should be fresh.
And boy, did he help get this thing started in the right direction, Adrian Dantley.
Hit 8 of his first 10 shots.
Number 11 on Isaiah.
And Isaiah Thomas coming in now. So here's where the Pistons have their top 2 scorers as Dumars goes out into the game. And a chance for Detroit to keep up the momentum against the Celtics.
Well, Isaiah committed that 2nd foul, and Chuck Daly very aware that Isaiah will be important in the second half. Saw the big lead, said, why chance a 3rd?
Thomas was out nearly 9 minutes. Vinny Johnson misses, and here's Seasting racing it up court. Bird, plenty of time, buries it.
Larry Bird. Seasting read that defense beautifully.
Bird has 15 now. 3:20 to go in the first half.
The Celtics have been down by big margins. Sometimes, because you know, fast break, they find it difficult to come back in clusters, and they peck away at you.
Dantley almost tied up by Roberts. Five on the shot clock. Thomas to Johnson. Sally tried to tip it in, Laimbeer. And Robert Parrish loops it out to Day. Bird. And Laimbeer. Here's the break. Dantley. 20 for Dantley. Bird right back goes by Laimbeer. He gets the rebound. Detroit 62-46. Get two more and a foul. A telling foul.
Well, Parrish is back on defense, but the attack is so fast, Parrish can't angle him off. And just as the body, Adrian Dantley picks up his third.
Parrish with three.
They call for it on the Devon coast of England. They call for it in the Bavarian Alps. And they call for it on Rush Street, Chicago, Illinois. Lowenbrau, brewed around the world. Taste it and you'll know why. Rich Bavarian hops and supervision brew fresh and smooth in America. It's the best way in the world to brew beer.
This world calls for Lowenbrau right now.
This water damage is going to run $750. What would have stopped it?
Thompson's Water Seal protects wood, brick, and concrete with its special waterproofing formula. Thompson's Water Seal, a great defense against repair expense.
There's a dumb mistake even I make sometimes. I tune up a car, but it doesn't run right. One spark plug wire wasn't pushed down tight. Autolite Power Seal wires click on so you know they're tight. Autolite Power Seals, the wires with the right connections.
You're really on the move, so you need a bank that can keep pace with you. Well, only a First Interstate Gold Bank card lets you cash a personal check up to $1,000 and get cash instantly at banking offices in more states and cities than any other bank. So come to First Interstate. We're not just keeping pace, we're setting the pace.
You ought to use that shot up first.
Well, Pat O'Brien had four hot dogs, but he looks as slim as ever. Pat, what's coming up at the half?
All right, Dick, thank you. Actually, we have a very busy halftime today. First, we're going to hear from the Lakers and the Sonics. They play game three tonight up in Seattle. Then David Robinson, is he the spur of the moment? And Butler will update that story. And you never know who's going to show up on at the half. Billy Packer makes an appearance to tell us about the United States Pan-American basketball team. All that and much more after a hot dog or two on the Prudential at the half. Back to Dick.
All right, Pat. Larry Bird with 15 points. McHale with 10. The top scorers for the Celtics. Dantley with 22. Laimbeer and Johnson each with 12 for the Pistons.
Going to see a great dish by Vinny Johnson. He made Parrish commit. That opened up a fairly decent attack angle for Adrian Dantley, and he can use that body and score against anybody.
Dennis Johnson and McHale on the bench. Robert Parrish also on the bench. He has three fouls, and Greg Kite replaced him. And here's Dantley, who has hit 10 of 13 shots from the field.
That's very significant that Robert Parrish picked up three fouls in this first half. Nobody's been able successfully to get the Celtics big guys in foul trouble.
And without Bill Walton, and he really has no chance of playing today at least, the Celtics really don't have a solid backup at center.
That's been the most remarkable thing about the Celtics team all season long.
Darren Day.
The big guys haven't gotten in foul trouble early.
Darren Day with a good move inside. Dantley coming back against Bird. He can do no wrong today. Adrian Dantley with 25.
Under 2 minutes to play in the second quarter.
Less than 2 minutes to go in the first half. Bird misses. Kite is there, and a loose ball foul against the Celtics.
And they say Kite was pushing Dick, but I think really what happened was Lambeer hooked him, and he was just trying to get his arm free.
You know, Greg Kite has developed that reputation, and he's never going to get the benefit of the doubt.
They call him on his jersey now.
Basket counts by Thomas, and a foul. What did Isaiah Thomas say? Well, it's 2-0. No one has ever beaten the Celtics after trailing 2-0. But no one ever had Isaiah. Well, the fact is, in 1985, the Celtics had a 2-0 lead. Isaiah was here, and the Celtics still won. But as you mentioned in the beginning, he really is the catalyst for this club. They go nowhere without him doing the right thing.
I tell you, he has to just control his emotions and understand that the other players on his team have to be involved. Don't take too much on his shoulders. Distribute the load.
Roberts gets a bucket. So the Pistons, who had their biggest lead of 21, see it cut to 19 with a minute 20 to go.
Boy, what a lonely feeling now. Feasting with Isaiah at the head of the key.
Thomas to Lambeer, open. You know, sometimes they make the game complex. I guess if you put the ball in the basket, Tommy, well enough, you can win any game.
When you penetrate like that, good shots open up because the back line and the defense adjust. They lose their concentration, and Isaiah now is taking advantage of that. He's playing the real creator.
Seasting that time. Vinny Johnson. Sally. The rebound and good leap by Vinny Johnson. Here's Lambeer again. And Darren Day. His foul, loose ball foul against Vinny Johnson. His second.
You watch Larry Bird become a creator on this play. He reads defenses, he sees everybody around them, and he knows Seasting will be able to get his shooting hand free, gets him the ball.
Bird goes out, but the cheers are for Vinny Johnson, who goes to the bench. Vinny Johnson scoring 12 points and all over the floor, making it happen defensively, passing the ball up, penetrating when he does, and getting some offensive rebound.
Well, he was about a three-alarmer in the first half. And the Celtics didn't get the fire hoses out in time.
He's replaced by Dumars. There's Darren Day. And the Celtics didn't use their bench as much in the regular season as they are in Missouri.
Well, right now, I think Casey Jones is saying, rest my regulars right now to make a real strong bid coming down in the second half.
Day steals the pass intended for Danley. Celtics trying to narrow the margin before halftime. But it's a big hill for them to climb. 8 on the shot clock for the Celtics. Fred Roberts against Dumars has an advantage. Score, no. Offensive foul against Fred Roberts.
Well, guards will do that against bigger players. A little bit of faking involved. As soon as they feel contact, they really fall to the floor. And officials have a tough time really judging whether it's an offensive foul or a block foul.
13 turnovers against Boston. Into 21 Detroit points.
Boston foul.
3 seconds to go, and Fred Roberts commits a foul that got to put a gray hair into the head of Casey Jones, and that is the 15th foul. So Isaiah Thomas will shoot two.
The real challenge now, Dick, was will be at halftime for the Pistons to continue this emotion into the second half, not get complacent, because the Celtics will lull them into a belief. That's what these players are on the court for right now by Casey Jones. Maybe to create a little feeling of overconfidence on a Pistons part.
Well, they're doing a good job of it. And that's the end of the first half. The Pistons lead the Celtics 73-53. Pat O'Brien will be back with the Prudential at the half from the Silver Dome after this message.
Plymouth Sundance, the unbelievable American, under $7,600. Everything you thought came only in an import is now born in America. 47 standard features, quality backed by a new 7-year or 70,000-mile protection plan. Plymouth Sundance. The brightest man, born in America.
Now get 3.7% financing or $500 cash back on Plymouth Sundance.
Heaven on earth.
Don't get him started about his car.
Hey, Pete, toss me the Quaker State.
This new Quaker State with QSX is a miracle. It gives car-carrying people superior engine protection.
Look at the sludge other leading motor oils leave behind. New Quaker State with QSX keeps your engine cleaner to last longer.
And that means I might spend the rest of my life in heaven.
Warn you.
Now reach for the best and grab a bargain. Save $360 on a case of new Quaker State.
Well, well, fancy this. Faucets, so fabulous, they appear to cost a fortune, but don't. For these are Price Pfister faucets. Far more than pretty faces, they're forged with a heart of solid brass, so you'll discover they're very fuss-free. All this at prices that make them a find, a real find. So do yourself a favor, get a Price Pfister, the fabulous faucet with a funny name.
The Celtics battling to repeat. The Pistons ignited by Isaiah. The Lakers led by MVP Magic. And the Cinderella hopes of the Supersonics. It's the NBA Conference Finals. When you look for champions, look to the NBA playoffs on CBS Sports.
CBS Sports presents The Prudential at the Half, sponsored by The Prudential, offering a full range of insurance and other financial services.
Well, if they made an automobile like this in Detroit, it'd be the car of the year. The Pistons are up by 20 over the world champion Boston Celtics. And Hagen, everybody, I'm Pat O'Brien. Once again, welcome to The Prudential at the Half. Let's get right to work here and talk about Game 3 day here in the NBA. The Western Conference Finals resume tonight. Game 3, as Seattle hopes there is such a thing as home court advantage. The Lakers lead 2-0, but the Supersonics don't intend to roll over. Let's begin with Bernie Bickerstaff.
When you get a team that has talent and they get confidence, anything can happen. And obviously, this is what this team is showing right now.
They're a gutsy ball club and with a lot of talent, and they've really conjured up some good chemistry, so nothing is surprises.
This team has performed very well when we have to. When we have our backs against the wall, we come out fighting and scrapping and do what we have to do to win.
It's not going to be flashy, fancy. It's going to be a fight, a war.
And speaking of Magic Johnson, the MVP trophy is on its way out here to East Lansing, Michigan. Magic Johnson picked up the trophy this week in L.A. and promptly said he's going to award it to Papa. Congratulations to both. As we reported last Sunday, the Clippers have named a new head coach, according to a report in an L.A. paper. The new Clippers skipper is Gene Shue, currently the fourth winningest coach in the NBA. Also out west, there's talk now that Don Nelson may end up as the general manager of the Golden State Warriors. And the third winningest coach and the only coach of the Dallas Mavericks quit this week. Dick Motta had come under criticism in Dallas for talking to the Knicks and the Clippers. He said he would never compromise his values for any job. After a news conference, he got into a pickup truck and drove away. We don't know where he'll park. And where will David Robinson's ship come in? To update that story, let's go to Ann Butler.
The San Antonio Spurs will pick first in the 1987 NBA draft.
The cadet who grew 6 inches in 4 years. Navy's best and the number one draft pick. San Antonio's got plenty of time.
We waited 14 years. What's two more?
It is safe to say that we will draft him.
David M. Robinson.
This week, pomp and circumstance at Annapolis. The basketball star is now an ensign. A college degree, a sigh of relief. Let the games begin. Right now, Robinson seems to be holding a handful of aces. He could sign with the Spurs and start signing paychecks. He could refuse to sign, wait till next year and re-enter the draft, or he could remain unsigned for 2 years and become a free agent. But there's a hitch besides his 2-year obligation to the Navy, an obscure bylaw from the NBA Constitution, something called the Armed Services List. Something that could preserve San Antonio's rights throughout his military career, something the Players Association just doesn't like.
It has nothing to do with the Armed Services List. So that David Robinson, at the end of 2 years, when his military career is over, would be free to go and play wherever he wanted to if he didn't sign before that time.
And so celebration becomes deliberation, even among members of the same camp.
The draft is designed to create parity in the league, and unless they do this, it would really be a sham.
If he isn't happy playing for San Antonio, then he won't sign with San Antonio.
But is David Robinson happy about playing in the NBA?
Oh, yes. Oh, yes. Oh, yes.
Hen Butler, CBS Sports.
Oh, yes. Well, he'll have to wait. In the meantime, David Robinson might wish he had studied law instead of engineering, because this one could very well end up in the courts. He could very well become the first NBA free agent, the Curt Flood of professional basketball. One thing is certain, David Robinson will play for the USA basketball team this summer at the Pan American Games in Indianapolis. This week, Denny Crum laid out his team. We sent Billy Packer to take a look for us.
Their names and faces are those of the best players in the country. But missing from the trials was one man head coach Denny Crum would not want to be without, Navy's David Robinson.
The selection committee gave him a waiver as far as attending practice because of his graduation. We didn't feel there was anyone in the country any better than he was, and that had he been able to participate here, he would have made the team anyway.
The action was fast and furious, which is what you would expect from players who are trying to represent their country. On Tuesday, the team was announced. At the center position, looked for David Robinson to lead the way, backed up by Dean Garrett. At the forward spot, Danny Manning and Purvis Ellison will certainly be at that position, but they can also play at the center spot. And look for Jerome Lane to be very tough on the boards. We'll have no problem at the guard spot, filling up the basket with the likes of Rex Chapman and Keith Smart. Among the notables not surviving the cut were Ronnie Cicely of Syracuse and J.R. Reed from North Carolina.
How good is this squad? Well, 4 years ago, Michael Jordan led our team to a gold medal in Caracas, Venezuela. In my opinion, this squad is every bit as talented, particularly on the inside. So look for the USA to rack up another gold medal in Indianapolis. From Colorado Springs, Billy Packer, CBS Sports.
And it's nice to see Billy Packer working on a Sunday. We've got a lot of people working today, and coming up after today's Eastern Conference final action, we're going to send you south for live coverage of the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic. And for a peek at what's in score, let's go live to Pat Summerall. Pat?
Thank you very much, Patrick. 14 under is the lead score right now, as it was after yesterday's round, but it's a different person up there. Bobby Watkins is at minus 14. Dave Bart, Davis Love the third at minus 13. Steve Pate at that same figure. But the story is evolving around Davis Love the third. It looked like it was going to be a runaway for him. Steve Melnick is here with me. He has more on that.
Patty came down with a virus overnight. It's affected him in the obvious ways, but more importantly, it's affected his balance.
I'm not feeling very well, but I've gotten a lot of rest the last day. All I've been doing is sleeping since about 8 o'clock yesterday, so hopefully I can get through the day without feeling any worse, but it's going to be a long day.
Is it an intestinal virus?
It's some kind of virus that a lot of people have been had going around, and one of the girls I'm staying with, in fact, has mono, so we're trying to get me over it real quick before I play.
Well, he thought about withdrawing this morning. We're glad to see him playing, but he's busy at the top.
And we look forward to a great third round. Now back to Pat O'Brien.
All right, Pat, thank you. I see the Celtics are coming back on the floor. Let's see what kind of tune-up they had. Dick and Tommy will talk about that as At the Half rolls on from Motown after a word from your local station. Stay with us.
It's a jungle. That's how it feels when you're searching for life insurance. The natives don't speak your language. You feel lost, in the dark, scared. But there is a sign of civilization. With Prudential, your agent will explain things clearly and work with you until you have a piece of the rock you feel comfortable with. No wonder more people choose Prudential for life insurance than any other company. You'll feel right by the rock. Prudential Life Insurance.
This is CBS.
Checks out fine. Everything's okay. It takes a lot of teamwork at Delta to give you the best service. And as a mechanic, I make sure everything's ready to go. All with one thing in mind, a safe, comfortable flight. Hey, Bob, we take a lot of pride in what we do. I like working on our airplanes, and I sure love working for Delta.
Delta, get you there. We get you there with care.
The guy is a victim of a multiple system deal his company made. Now management can't get operations help. The PC users can't get the power they want. He's mad at his vendors. He's mad at me. It's nobody's fault. Anyway, I recommend the Wang BS. Don't trash his old systems. Get management what they need. Bring all his PC users together. Keep his meat and potatoes applications. Just tie it all together with a VS. perfect. And he saw that. And when he saw that, tears came into his eyes.
Come on.
Well, sort of.
When you use the AT&T Long Distance Network, you can enjoy a relaxing conversation.
Hello, Planet Chaos.
Over the last 3 years, AT&T has lowered prices 30%.
I hear you loud and clear.
Lower prices, another way we're reaching further to bring your world closer.
I'm so glad you called. You're the first Earth person I've talked to all day.
AT&T, the right choice.
Tune the town in Florida's Disney World Tuesday at 7:30.
We're back at the Silver Dome, where the Detroit Pistons have a whopping 20-point lead over the Boston Celtics, 73-53. Here are some significant statistics. Detroit's shooting 61% so far today, far and away better than they have in the series. Boston is actually a little bit better. Look at the front line scoring. That's a big surprise, since the Celtics conceded the big edge in that area to the three of the Boston Celtics. And of course, fast break. Detroit, how did it get it going? And 21-2. And Tommy, that third statistic may be the key to why Detroit has come back so far.
There's no question, Dick, that the pace really paid off for the Pistons. Right now, they've got to really forget about complacency. Cockiness is okay, but complacency can't be any part of their game. They've got to continue the same type of pace game that they played in the first half. That's tough to do with a 20-point lead.
Well, this was a cocky team that maybe didn't handle things right going into the pressure of the conference final first two games. It's helped them come back in the first half, but they can't revert. We'll see what happens in the second half when we come back in a moment.
Only you.
Just because you've washed your car doesn't mean you're finished. After each wash, you need some Armor All on the dash, the bumper, and especially the tires. Armor All, it's the finishing touch every time you wash your car.
You're my dream.
And now, introducing Clean Start, the new cleaner which safely removes tough dirt. Clean Start, only from Armor All products.
What a bright future I have. I like Sylvania bulbs. Long-lasting bulbs for your home. All kinds of energy-saving lights. And look, Sylvania put me in spotlights, garden lights, and thousands of other bulbs. Try some. I'll do a brilliant job for you.
Honey, who turned on all the lights?
Ask for Sylvania, where the best comes to light.
Today's small cars are tougher than ever on oil. Their high-compression engines not only rev high, they can run hotter than regular small car engines. Their searing heat can begin to break down an oil immediately. That's why there's Castrol, the only leading motor oil that in every grade provides maximum protection against viscosity and thermal breakdown. So use Castrol before your engine does something to get you heated up. Castrol, engineered for today's smaller cars.
America's game. It's fantastic.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by Nissan's Pathfinder. Named best 4x4 of the year by both 4-Wheeler and 4-Wheel and Off-Road magazines. Miller Lite. For great taste, there's only one light beer. And by Honda Power Equipment. Lawnmowers, riding mowers, and portable generators made to last.
And with a 20-point lead for the Pistons at halftime, more bad news for the Boston Celtics. Robert Parrish has been declared out of the rest of this game. Apparently, he must have aggravated that injured ankle. And Pat O'Brien is near the Celtic dressing room with a report. Pat, what did you find out?
All right, thank you, Dick. I just talked to the trainer of the Celtics. Parrish did indeed re-injure that left ankle. He re-sprained it. He will not come back for today's game, but they say he might be able to play. Excuse me, sir. He might be able to play tomorrow. Let's go back to you, Dick.
All right, Pat, thank you very much for finding that out. And, of course, you know, you don't know whether with a 20-point lead they knowing there's a game tomorrow, Tommy, that they just want to say, let's get him out of there now. But apparently he did aggravate it again. And, of course, not that much time before tomorrow's game. Here's the Celtics scoring in the first half. .53 points, not bad for the Boston Celtics for a first half, or for anyone, but Detroit with an amazing 73 and five men in double figures, including off the bench Vinnie Johnson.
Boy, and Vinnie with the six assists to augment Isaiah Thomas's five assists. That is impressive. They distributed the ball beautifully so that everybody could be involved. Now, you know what that presents? Who do I stop to Casey Jones for tomorrow's ball game? Big problem.
Detroit unbeaten in the Silverdome. By the way, they took two out of three from the Celtics in the regular season here, but Larry Bird did not play in both of Detroit's wins. Seaston misses the first shot of the second half. Mahorn outlets to Dumars. So it's Dumars, Isaiah Thomas, Mahorn, Lambeer, and Dantley. Dantley with his 25 points is a playoff high this year for a half. Dantley. And Bird gets the rebound. The Celtics, I'm sorry, are going with the same five that started the game, except Day in place of Parrish.
Last time the Pistons had the ball, they really didn't push it hard. That's what I'm looking for right now, to see how quickly they advance the ball.
Bird with six on the clock, and Johnson lost it out of bounds. Pistons ball. They're the leading scorers in the game, and Dantley with an 11 for 14 brilliant shooting first half to help the 61% Detroit shooting.
Now they can fall into the situation where they're going to try and play perhaps half court game against half court game.
And Darren Day got a hand on it.
That is not good for the Pistons. I think the Celtics are going to execute their half court offense a little bit better than the Pistons can.
Dumars penetrates and draws the foul. And it's against Darren Day, his second foul. Dumars has been paired with Dennis Johnson in the first two games, and this is what it was in the first two games. The edge going to Dennis Johnson. Dumars has 10 points on 5 for 7 shooting so far in this game, and DJ has 6 points. Dumars misses the first.
He is a great weapon for this ball club, Joe Dumars. Excellent ball handler. Not many clubs have two real good passes in the backcourt.
Bird posting up against Mahorn. And Dumars comes in, and a foul is called against Mahorn.
They are not doubling Larry Bird, but look at that fight for position down there by McHale. What's Seasting doing in there?
Not in there anymore. Bird, short. And Mahorn gets the rebound. Dantley filling the lane and now pushing it up as Thomas. Popping is Lambeer.
Now that's a weapon that we did not see at all in game one or two. Lambeer as a trailer on the fast break with that good outside shot.
23-point lead is the biggest of the ball game right now for the Pistons. But they commit another foul. And Lambeer now with his first foul. The Pistons, not only playing as well as they can play, are totally out of foul trouble as McHale hits the jumper.
Now they will try to exploit the inside game against going to Kevin McHale against Bill Lambeer.
McHale trying to slough off of Lambeer when it doesn't look like he's going to get the ball. He doubles. Good pass by Lambeer to Dumars.
And a quick swing of the ball before Boston's defense could even come close to rotating.
Bird against Mahorn. McHale. Gets the rebound. If you just joined us and we're away at halftime, Robert Parrish is not coming back in the second half for the Celtics. He re-aggravated that ankle. Darren Day commits the foul, and it's a Piston Day all the way.
Introducing power and price you've never seen in a compact 4x4. The new lower-priced Nissan Hardbody V6.
We got the power to make you move. We make you feel like driving.
More horsepower, dollar for dollar, than any leading compact truck. Big and broad, high and wide. There's nothing ordinary about this truck. Nothing but the price.
Your face takes enough abuse without your disposable razor hurting it more. Now, Gillette introduces Good News Plus, the new disposable with a white Lubra Smooth Strip designed to reduce pulling and skin irritation.
Hurts so bad!
Finally, there's a disposable that feels so good. Good News Plus, new from Gillette, the essence of shaving.
I've been doing a lot of thinking lately about Miller Lite. What a profound concept. It's got a third less calories than I probably thought it didn't even have. And it's less filling than it would have been if it was more filling than they didn't want it to be. Plus, it tastes as great as you expect, if it had more calories than it didn't have in the first place. Think about that.
In other words, there's only one light beer, because if there wasn't, he wouldn't be saying there is. Right, yo?
In 18 years, nobody's managed to repeat. That was then. These are the Celtics. The playoffs continue tomorrow on CBS Sports.
The quick swing of the ball defeats the rotation of the Celtics double team. Jerry Seasting right here, and Dennis Johnson, our key players. Dennis Johnson will come over here to try and help out on the point man, and here comes Seasting around, gets bumped off on the pick, and can't quite get to the shooter. Watch what happens. Before Seasting can even get there, Dumars has raised for the shot, and it's off, away, and in.
And that was Laimbeer who made that play, and Laimbeer, who averaged only 6 points in the first two games of the series and was roundly criticized, has scored 16 today, and a good all-round game for Bill. Pistons trying to establish a 25-point lead, which would be their largest, and it keeps growing. Six on the clock. Dumars. And Darren Day gets the rebound with 3 minutes gone by in this third period.
And they have played more half-court offense in this quarter, the Pistons, than they have fast breaks.
It's still Celtics ball. Tommy, do you think, I know how you feel about the fact that they should keep pushing it up, but maybe they can try to sharpen their half-court offense a little bit against Boston.
I think that you do the thing you're supposed to do for the entire series first. Make sure that works.
Day gets the layup. 78-57. Pistons led by 9 after one quarter.
Pretty tough to take time off the clock, work it down when you've got 24 minutes.
Isaiah Thomas has 12.
You sometimes defeat your own momentum when you slow it down, Dick, your own aggressiveness.
Could it have a carryover to the next game?
Maybe not, but stay aggressive for the entire game. That's what I think.
7 on the shot clock. Dennis Johnson. And McCann. Fighting for the offensive rebound, gets the basket and a foul. And that was just a sensational second and third effort by Kevin McHale on that play. 14 for McHale, 2 fouls now on Laimbeer.
Well, the Celtics will not roll over, and here's a typical example. He will stay on the boards, 2-3 tips. In a 20-point game, it's easily to get discouraged and give up on that offensive rebound, but not McHale.
And even though it's a 21-point lead and a huge lead for Detroit, he missed the free throw. Any team that could do what the Celtics did and come from 8 points down late in the game against Milwaukee in a 7th game, they can do anything.
They know how to peck away at a 20-point lead, perhaps better than anybody, and they don't lose their poise.
No. 7:48 on the clock in the third. Thomas and Bird looking for the outlet, and Mahorn did a good job of preventing that. Dennis Johnson leans in, and Bird fighting, and it's still Celtics ball. Larry Bird plays every game as if the next shot will win it.
looks like it's his last game. That's how hard he plays. Here's Mahorn just nudges him off the court. No whistle.
Day.
Darren Day.
Lead now 80-61.
You know, when you stop running, it's awfully difficult to change gears and pick up the pace once again, and it's slowly turning to the pace the Celtics like.
Thomas off the screen. And it's 82-61. The Pistons with a lead and playing half court now in this third period. And now the fourth illegal defense call against the Pistons, and it'll be the third technical foul attempt when we return with 6:57 to go in a big lead for Detroit. Still.
When you buy a new lawnmower, you want to believe that each one will be the last you'll ever have to buy. But in time, it becomes painfully clear that not all lawnmowers are engineered to last. Knowing this, why would you settle for anything less than a Honda? Year after year, the right tool for mowing the lawn.
When a family moves, State Farm is there.
I'm State Farm agent Bob Scatina. This family, the Nilsons, just moved into town. They said it took them a while to find a new doctor and a new dentist, but finding a new insurance agent was easy. They liked the way their State Farm agent back in Montana handled all their family insurance, so all they had to do was look for this sign. And you could find one almost anywhere.
And like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
You work your one and only body like you never have before.
Questions, Gatorade is Thursday.
So go and give your thirsty body what it's feeling thirsty for.
Questions, Gatorade is Thursday. For that deep down body thirst.
Nothing cuts through thirst like Gatorade Thirst Quencher. It speeds in fluids and minerals and supplies energy to working muscles.
Questions, Gatorade is Thursday. For that deep down body thirst.
We have the third round of the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic coming up after this game today. And, of course, more coming up this weekend on Memorial Day weekend, the NBA playoffs, the conference finals. Tomorrow afternoon, Tom and I will be back here at the Silver Dome for game four of this Eastern Conference final between the Celtics and the Pistons at 3:30 Eastern time. And then on Monday at 3:00 Eastern time, Brent Musburger and Billy Cunningham will be at the Seattle Coliseum for game four of the Lakers-Seattle series. The Lakers lead 2-0, and later today will go against the Sonics in game three in Seattle.
Well, we're going to see if the Sonics will have the same type of luck against the Lakers on their home court as the Pistons are against the Celtics. Both are real conference winners during the regular season, enjoying a 2-game lead.
Sonics played the Lakers pretty tough, though they lost the 2 games.
And much better against the Lakers than the Pistons did against Boston in Boston.
Celtics missed a chance to get a point back, and Day is fouled. That's Adrian Dantley's second personal foul. And the fourth team foul against the Pistons. Now, the Celtics still struggling. Or should stay struggling from the field in this half. They shot well in the first half of this game.
Oh, that's no good. That's no good.
And no basket. Lane violation.
No basket. Lane violation.
Against the Celtics, so it'll be Detroit ball. Dick Stockton and Tom Heinsohn. It's the third period here at the Silver Dome in Pontiac, and the shift in scene has also been a shift in the Pistons' aggressiveness and style of play. And trailing 2-0, they've opened up a huge lead over the Boston Celtics. Dantley is fouled by Darren Day, who picks up number 4. And after this game, Tommy, it'll be Casey Jones, if it goes the way it's going, who's going to have to come up with some answers.
Well, he'll probably come up with, devise some kind of way to stop that fast break attack. Going to be awfully difficult, but I'm sure he'll come up with something to keep in this series.
More important, they're going to have to hope that they get a healthy Robert Parrish back.
That's the big problem right now. That's going to put the emphasis on Kevin McHale to do a major portion of the rebounding on both ends of the court, and he's got a fractured foot.
Lane Beer with 18 now. Darren Day coming back, and Day has 10 points. C-State. Now, the one thing Bird did the other night effectively was to get the bench going when they were in there. Seasting on a nifty steal.
Celtics have not really been able to make inroads, but the pace very much the way they want it. They'll peck away, take good shots. It's easier for them to play half-court defense than it is fast break defense, the Celtics.
And Mahorn committing the foul, and that's the 15th foul. And the Celtics will go to the line, so they're in the bonus.
Well, there's a man that would have been very important in this series, has not been able to play because of a ligament problem in his knee. Outside shooter, Danny told me before the game that he was going to, felt he'd be ready in 2 or 3 days. And I'm sure the whole Celtic crew and the people in Boston would like to see that happen.
He's had problem moving laterally, and that's why he hasn't been in there. 84-66 Detroit, 5.5 to play in the third period.
The object right now for Boston is get it down to 10 points by the end of the third quarter.
And it's something they can easily do with enough time. And Danley misses an inside shot. And there's no question that the Pistons have coasted a bit in this third period, and a lot of the air has gone out of their, a lot of the helium, I should say, has gone out of their high sky balloon.
Well, the Celtics have come back from big leads down through the years, and they know how to do it.
Bird with 17, and you know Chuck Daly's got to be concerned. If you want to say concerned with a big lead against this team, he should be concerned.
Dig down deep. That's what the Celtics will do.
Dumars penetrating. And Day gets the rebound, and the Celtics on an 11-4 run with plenty of time to cut it down in this third period.
And they've taken all good shots on offense. Some of them haven't gone in, but they've been all good shots.
Bird.
Three!
And a 3-second violation called against the Celtics. Couldn't decide Day or Bird to shoot. Dennis Rodman is getting off the bench. He'll come in. Vinnie Johnson is also in the ball game. So Chuck Daly looking at maybe a couple of stale guys out there going for some reinforcements.
They are not into the pace game. Their heads are completely out of it. They may be trying to reassert that with Vinnie Johnson and Rodman.
Thomas going by Dennis Johnson, feeding Mahorn for the basket. Isaiah the creator on that play.
He has to be a real creator throughout this entire series.
McHale is fouled by Lane Beer, who claims he had the ball. Lane Beer is no favorite amongst the Celtics or their fans. As Larry Bird said, we don't like him that good.
That's not bad. Look at this pass, though. Bird knows how to pass the ball. He may say good instead of like or whatever, but he sure knows how to hit the right man and get Lane Beer in a lot of trouble.
We don't like him that good.
We don't like him that good.
That says it.
The secret to making a big comeback is take it easy, get good shots, don't lose your poise, and play good defense. Now, the half-court offense that Detroit is playing right now, it's easier for the Celtics to defend that than against the fast break.
Bird goes out, gets a breather with 17 points, and replaced by Fred Roberts. McHale made one of two, and he has 17, but only 5 of 13 from the field. Vinnie Johnson misses the shot, knocked away by McHale, still Detroit ball. So Kevin McHale is having a rough time shooting in this game, and once again we have to go back to that defensive switch that the Pistons made at the start of this game.
Well, Lambeer on him will muscle him too, like Mahorn would.
There's Mahorn.
Now that is a big pass. The penetration evident there on the last two hoops that the Pistons made the back line of the Celtics defense adjust.
Mahorn has 9 rebounds in the game and 4 points. Darren Day going in, gets the basket and the foul. And a quick move by Darren Day, who was picked up on waivers in December, had played with the Bullets and one day with the Chicago Bulls.
Puts a move on Sally, and he's got pretty good speed and dribbling ability, so he can take it strong with one bounce to the ball and still put it high off the glass.
Without Robert Parrish, here is today's frontline matchup. And it's made a big difference. Dennis Johnson is out of the game, and Sam Vincent comes back in.
Well, Darren Day is showing that he's got some offensive ability in this quarter, and Sam Vincent will get him a lot of experience, I would think, right now, playing Isaiah Thomas even more than he has during the summer months.
And a 3-second violation. 3:06 remaining in the third, 88-72. So the Pistons, despite the fact that they haven't been able to run this period and stop, 16-point lead. The biggest was 23, and still a good margin. And Sam Vincent is fouled going to the hoop. And Rick Mahorn was right there. The foul is on Mahorn, his third. And we'll come back with that much time remaining, and that's the score here in the third.
You know, this is my favorite bar, because everyone here drinks Miller Lite for the same reason I do, because it tastes great. Yeah, my kind of crowd. Yeah.
For big taste, there's only one light beer, Miller Lite.
4x4s came in lots of shapes and sizes this year, but only one was named Best 4x4 of the Year. Nissan Pathfinder, honored by both four-wheel and off-road and four-wheeler magazines.
Best of the Year in on- and off-road performance.
Best of the Year for interior comfort and function.
Award-winning ride, toughness, and style found in Pathfinder and every 4x4 we make. The 4x4 of the Year is Pathfinder. The name is Nissan.
Maybe you'll be lucky. Maybe you'll just have to replace your connecting rods. But maybe you'll need new valves. Then your bearings and crankshaft could go. Maybe even your rings and pistons. But you can help prevent all this for just a few dollars with a Fram Wear Guard oil filter. A leading consumer magazine rated Fram Best. So you can pay a few dollars now or a lot later.
This is my favorite bar, because everyone here drinks Miller Lite for the same reason I do, because it's less filling. Yeah, my kind of crowd.
Whoa, must be in the wrong commercial.
For big taste, there's only one light beer, Miller Lite.
Sunday.
A 1 pound, 4 ounce baby. We've saved him smaller than that.
Dot, I'll do anything.
John Lithgow and Mary Beth Hurt, baby girl Scott.
All right, let's find out what Pat O'Brien is up to. Pat?
All right, Dick, thank you. You know, I'm a gadget freak. I had to show you this one. This is Chuck Daly's blackboard. It's really called an electronic whiteboard. He can sit here and draw plays for his players, and he presses this button, and automatically the plays come out down here, so the players can take their plays home and look at them and study them. Rick Mahorn said, well, it's just another blackboard to me. By the way, Dick, I had a reminder here. Call Leslie. Nothing important. Just call her after the game. Let's go back to you.
Well, you know, I hate to tell you, Pat, but she's covering the Lakers-Seattle series for the Boston Globe, so I know exactly where she is. I just hope Danny Ainge and Ray Melchiori isn't calling her right now. What's that all about, Tom?
I'm sure they're trying to check on Robert Parrish and what's happening with him inside. But Ray likes to fool around with gadgets.
Yeah.
Get the helicopter here. I need the helicopter.
Sam Vincent will be on the free throw line. Tom, I know you've made this point and about the Pistons not really pressuring the Celtics here. And I think what you would say is going for the jugular. I mean, the fact is that the Celtics have a chance to knock it down to 10 before this period is over, which is no guarantee they can come back and win. But the Pistons are giving them a chance to get back in the game.
They certainly are. And what the Pistons are going to have to do is execute their half-court offense, search out the best matchup that they think that is available to them.
What do you think the best matchup is?
Right now, it's going to be Vinnie Johnson, I would think, being guarded by Seastick.
Thomas hits a long one just inside the three-point line.
And, of course, that's not a bad matchup either, Isaiah against anybody.
In other words, the backcourt.
Yep.
2:25 remaining in the third. Sally is guarding Fred Roberts. Bird has been on the bench getting a breather. Roberts in trouble, gets it to Day, and Darren Day scores. He now has 12 points in this third period, 15 in the game, and he has played a bigger role as anyone to keep the Celtics within range, man.
He certainly has shown more offensive ability than anybody's thought he's had in Boston for a long time.
Thomas, off the glass.
Big hoop there. Isaiah's starting to take over. And maybe that's what the Pistons will have to do down the stretch. Give it to Isaiah and make it happen with Isaiah.
92-76, Detroit picked up on a switch by Sally. Vincent finds an open day. Rodman closed in a hurry. Good defense by Rodman. On the rotation by Detroit. Now here's Vinnie Johnson against Seasting, the matchup you like. Plenty of time on the shot clock.
They're looking for Isaiah, really.
McHale now on the switch.
As Mahon really had knocked off Vincent with a pick and sealed him behind him.
No choice but for Sam Vincent to foul him.
First in the last 2 minutes.
I couldn't even see Sam Vincent for 2 seconds as he tried to get around Mahon.
Here's what's happening for the reserves. The Celtics have a big edge, but a lot of that is deceiving because Robert Parrish didn't come out in the second half. And with the Celtics down by as much as 23, Darren Day and Kite and Vincent have seen a lot of action. So that may be deceiving the bench scoring in this game.
I think you're exactly right, Dick.
Mahorn into Sally. Good position for Sally. And Rodman is fouled. Roberts played Sally well inside, but then came Rodman, who is the 27th pick in the draft out of Southeast Oklahoma State and has good young legs.
Well, they have a little pick action inside. Sally got good spot inside and then really couldn't throw anything up but a brick. And there's Day on Rodman on the rebound. He's having trouble hitting the front of the rim the last two games on free throw.
Kite replaces Day, who goes out with 5 personal fouls. So 5 on Darren Day.
What a major effort by Darren Day offensively, and he's been playing defense pretty well in this series.
Crowd gives Rodman a boost with under a minute to play in the third period. Seasting, top of the key.
Good look to find the open man by McHale. You know, the other aspect of this, the 2 games in 2 days, if the Celtics could be a tired team on Saturday, you can make them tired on Saturday. Imagine how tired they would be on Sunday. That's why the pace also might have been important in this second half.
Illegal defense called against the Celtics.
Here's a shot you don't see every day. Oh, that reminds me of Bob Cousy in his old heyday. Off the wrong foot.
Thomas going baseline. Nearly lifted it in. Seasting, great pass to Vincent. Basket counts and a foul, and it was Jerry Seasting. Practically a no-touch pass to Sam Vincent that made that possible 3-point play possible.
I'll tell you right now, I believe Casey Jones made a very wise substitution by getting Greg Kite into this game, putting a wide body to take up some room underneath that basket, particularly for defensive rebound purposes.
And a career high playoff total of 12 now for Sam Vincent. And it's a 12-point game. So the Celtics trail by 12. Difference of 2 seconds between the shot clock and the game clock. And Larry Bird will come in fresh, believe me, in the beginning of this fourth period. 1 second and they don't get it off. The 24-second clock goes off with 2 seconds to go for the Celtics. And they have come from behind by more than this deficit, believe me, in a shorter distance. And Bird and Dennis Johnson will be in there. Mahorn and McHale exchanging an elbow or two the other end.
Celtics have come back with out Robert Parrish, without Dennis Johnson an awful lot this quarter. They're going to have their guns for the fourth quarter.
And Vincent very nearly made that shot. That's the end of the third period. The Celtics have come back here. They trail the Pistons 93-81, and we'll be back after this word from your local station.
This is CBS.
It's not Jamaica. It's Las Vegas, man. Only at the Tropicana.
One of these Japanese luxury sedans comes with a 2.4-liter electronically fuel-injected engine. One comes with a 6-speaker AM-FM stereo cassette system. At no extra charge. One supplies a theft deterrent system as standard equipment. And one retained a phenomenal 99% of its original retail value over the past year. Which one? The less expensive one. Mitsubishi Galant. Immediate delivery now at your Mitsubishi Motors dealer.
If you don't deserve the best, who does? Heineken. Satisfy your thirst for the best.
It's Wiener Schnitzel's new big and beefy. Try our Reuben dog with sauerkraut, Swiss cheese, and a crisp dill pickle. Nobody hot dogs it like we do.
Hollywood's Fast Track Stars, Sunday at 6 and 11.
When you see a player headed for trouble, you call timeout.
Timeout!
That way you stop mistakes that lose games.
Works in life, too. When you see a friend take the wheel after too many drinks, you know where he's headed. Arrest. Humiliation. A heavy price to pay. When you see a friend headed for that kind of trouble, call timeout.
Stop the mistake that'll cost him a lot more than a game.
CBS Sports coverage of the 1987 NBA playoffs is sponsored by Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? Liberty Mutual for your auto, home, life, and business insurance. And by Fram, Bendix, and Autolite, which are all quality products of Allied Automotive.
And the crowd in Detroit giving their Pistons a send-off as they start the fourth period. Tommy Larry Bird is back. Dennis Johnson is back with Roberts, Kite, and Vincent. And the Celtics know that they cut off a 20-point lead down to 12, made up 8 points in the third. Lane Beer and Sally, Rodman, Dennis Johnson, and Isaiah Thomas and Dumar. And Isaiah Thomas gets a big first hoop. That's a big basket.
They ran their half-court offense, and Isaiah ran off three picks to lose Sam Vincent and then just arced that shot over his head.
Bird. And the rebound by Rodman.
Detroit has to give Boston only one shot.
Giving that extra effort makes winners. Be all you can be, sponsored by the U.S. Army. The role player is a critical part of any winning team. He concentrates on particular skills and is called upon in the game's most critical moments. He resists doing things out of character and saves acclaim for others. By embracing a strong work ethic, a role player like Jim Peterson is being the best he can be.
Hey, could I tap some of your computer expertise, son?
So you finally gave in.
Yeah, for starters, how does the disk fit into the disk drive?
Okay, the Army can train you to program, operate, or fix computers.
What does the printer interface do?
It lets the computer talk to the printer.
They talk to each other. What do they say?
And then there's a telephone modem hookup.
And the computer training you get is yours forever.
Be all that you can be.
Like you're not going to be the only computer expert in the valley.
Thank you. Coming up next, third round action in the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic. And for a report, let's go down to Pat Summerall. Pat.
Well, thank you very much, Dick. Bobby Watkins and Dave Barr surprisingly hold the lead, share the lead at minus 15. Davis Love has faltered. He had the intestinal flu, and after those back-to-back 65s, his game has not been quite as sharp. As you look down the second page of our leaderboard, you see that there are still a lot of big names well within shot and in sight of the leaders. Ken Venturi, why the score is so low?
Well, the condition is so good, Pat, and they talk about Davis Love being ill, but you cannot throw away the great play of Bobby Watkins, Dave Barr, and Steve Pate. They are shooting just some great golf today.
Bobby Watkins has never won in America. We'll see what happens. Now let's go back to Dick Stockton.
Thank you very much, Pat. And I guess this is Detroit's house.
The Silver Dome.
Pistons have scored four quick points to start this final period. Seasting looking for Burr, trying to post up against Rodman. A lot of shoving going on inside. And an offensive foul called against Burr. Three on Bird.
Bird trying to get it going. Get good position to low post. He's really hooked Rodman with his arm. And Rodman knew it. And he's certainly glad that the referee saw it, too.
Bird is on Lambeer. Roberts on Rodman. And Kite is on Salad. Thomas goes around Seaston. Doesn't get the roll and fought for. The Pistons inside Sally, and they call the offensive foul.
They just nudged them completely under the backboard.
Was it a foul or just lost by the Pistons?
I think you hit the bottom of the backboard.
Right, okay. No foul. 97-81, Pistons. Came into this game losing the first two at Boston Garden, knowing they had to win this game to have any kind of hope of getting back in the series.
Well, they certainly have responded to the challenge, but they got that master man there trying to find open people.
Seasting. And the 24-second clock goes down, and Bird and Lambeer go at it. I don't remember Larry Bird getting as angry as I saw him there.
Well, Bird would stand for getting pulled down on a layup, but not on a play like that with the clock running down. And he really got taken down very hard. And, of course, Bird is very upset at Lambeer and has been for a long time.
Now Rodman goes after Bird threw the ball. This thing's out of control. I've never seen Larry Bird react that way, and you know, you have to take him to the limit for him to do that.
You know, when Larry Bird would be on a fast break is one thing, but to go down the way he went down in the low post, taking a shot up in the air with the clock running down. And now we got some crazy fans here throwing ice on the court, which would delay the game and foment further trouble. Let's take a look at it. Before the play starts, here's Bird trying to really pop out. Rodman's got him. They seal Rodman so that Bird can just get the ball. Here's Bird trying to work one-on-one. Clock going off. There's the double team. Bird finds Seasting over in the corner, gets the ball back. Up fake to Rodman, and then Lambeer just takes him down, and that is not a good takedown.
Lambeer and Bird have both been ejected as a result of fighting fouls. Larry Bird and Bill Lambeer have both been ejected from the game.
Now, there's Bird throwing the ball at Lambeer, and Rodman coming over at Bird.
Bird would not have been ejected if he hadn't thrown the ball
at
Lambeer.
That's exactly right. And Bird is the consummate cool player, so he blew completely on that play. And look at
the scratches on his face. Gone. stupid fans are throwing debris at Larry Bird as he leaves. I wouldn't want to have to guard Larry Bird tomorrow.
Let's take another peek at this play. Seasting lays the pass out. Everybody in the back line had to adjust as Rodman over, and then Lambia just grabbed him right around the neck, and that is not the type of play that you take a player down on. You hit him on the arm or you hit him in the head a little bit, but it's not a takedown play.
You can get real, you can hurt your back on a play.
Absolutely.
Like that.
Detroit's ball on the side. Let's go.
Lambeer deserved to be ejected.
I
think Bird
so.
Deserved to be ejected
for throwing
the
ball.
Right.
Casey Jones right saying right now, I deserve something here too. Give me a break underneath the boards. And he'll work the officials right now, hoping to gain a little bit of psychological advantage. And this could steam up the Celtics.
Yeah, this is not going to hurt the Celtics in a game four tomorrow, Tommy.
No, and it may not hurt them right now in the fourth quarter here either. And I think Darryl Garrett's trying to talk to Casey Jones to try and say, calm your ball club down a little bit. But I don't think the Celtics will calm down.
24-second violation on that play as Bird didn't get the shot up. There's the story, a 16-point lead and only 2 minutes gone by in the fourth period. Kite against Mahorn. Lead for the Pistons. Their biggest lead was 23. They had a 20-point lead at halftime and a three-point shot by Jerry Seasting.
As where Danny Ainge was so important in comebacks to hit those three-point plays, Seasting will have to try and hit a few in order to bring him back.
Thomas for three comes right back. I think there was an answer to that message with Thomas gone for the three. And a delay of game warning against the Pistons. Tommy, I think people already have their appetites wet for tomorrow's fourth game, no matter what happens the rest of this one.
I don't know if anybody be watching, but I'm going to be here to see what happens because Larry Bird is mad.
You might have a couple of people watching anyway. Dennis Johnson. Sally. To Rodman. And the lead is 20 again, and the two rookies combined there. This crowd's loving it. Bird ejected. Lambeer ejected. And Dennis Johnson drives in for two. And keep in mind, the Celtics have not played the second half without Robert Parrish, or played without Robert Parrish, who re-injured his ankle. Sally is fouled as he goes up. And this series will continue tomorrow, game four, here at the Silverdome. We'll be with you at 3:30 Eastern time and the rest of the series. Should there be a sixth game, we will be here in Pontiac Thursday night at 9:00 Eastern for game six, but that's a long way away. Connor Henry has checked in for the Celtics as Seasting takes a breather.
Connor Henry is a three-point shooter, and I think at this particular point, Casey Jones has not totally conceded the game, but Connor Henry will have difficulty defending against Isaiah Thomas.
Henry did not play in the first two games of the series. He's appeared in 5 of 12 playoff games. Started the year with Houston. McHale and the pass by Dennis Johnson overthrown.
Number 31,
Fred Roberts.
Casey Jones is making a prudent move right here.
Yeah, resting McHale.
McHale and Dennis Johnson, who have played so many minutes, back-to-back games, very important that they be fresh for tomorrow.
So Casey Jones is conceding this game. That doesn't mean that if these guys who are out there now don't bring it back close, you may see him again. But basically, he's saying, I'm going to play the percentages now and rest my veterans.
And I wouldn't be a bit surprised to see some of these Celtic players play a little rock and sock and basketball against these Pistons right now.
Vincent. Yeah, going in, and an offensive foul called against Connor Henry. It's 106-86. And coming into this game, the Pistons were down 2-0, and this really was the game for them. If they had lost, it would have been sayonara in this series. And by winning today, and it looks like they will win this game, the Detroit Pistons have a chance to even the series tomorrow. Day leading the break to Henry.
Connor Henry and Darren Day.
Fight really fired up the Pistons also, and they become much more aggressive on their own offense, and that's been a good sign for them. But they really played great basketball in that first half to get that 20-point lead by halftime,
and a 3-second violation called against Detroit. Dennis Johnson has hurt his elbow. He's had an elbow problem earlier in the year. Maybe this is where it happened, Tommy.
Well, he drove to the basket and kind of collided with somebody, made the basket, but hit his elbow on the floor. And that's going to be a hurting thing for DJ.
Vincent using a kite screen. Mahorn the rebound. Talk about fired up people. You know Bird will be, but I think Bill Laimbeer will be also for Detroit. Sally. Reverse the layup. And a foul against Sally, tripping Vincent. And a timeout, 6:44, and Darren Day limping a bit.
To demonstrate the computerized suspension system on the new Thunderbird Turbo Coupe, we're going to feed it the following information. The result is an automobile that adjusts instantly to the road's twists and turns. This is the new intercooled Thunderbird Turbo Coupe from Ford.
Have you driven a Ford lately?
Disposable has a new blade angle that's designed to give you a light touch. An easy touch that's closer than ever.
A touch that's easy makes me understand. When it comes to love, I want a slow hand.
The new Shift Disposable for the easy touch.
For 75 years, Liberty Mutual has shown companies like IBM, companies like General Mills, companies like Ramada Inns, and thousands of others how to make their workers' compensation dollars work harder. As a result, they've made Liberty Mutual the largest insurer of America's working men and women.
America believes in liberty. Liberty Mutual Insurance.
Some of the year's biggest money winners take on the scenic but challenging terrain at the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic on CBS Sports next.
We have a report from Pat O'Brien. Pat?
All right, Dick, thank you. This is the entrance to the locker rooms. As you might imagine, quite a bit of activity going on back there. Let's take it in chronological order. I talked with Robert Perry. She did indeed aggravate his left ankle. He was very, very disappointed, depressed, he said, and he wanted Boston fans to know that he'd give it his best shot to come back tomorrow. Now the fight. Bill Laimbeer told me on the way off, he said, Pat, I didn't do a damn thing. That's a quote. Larry Bird, in no uncertain terms, said no comment. So let's go back to Dick.
Well, thank you, Pat. Good report on many areas. I know one thing. I don't know where it happened, but Larry Bird went down very hard, and it looked like a very hard takedown, as we said. Larry Bird threw the ball. I think we're going to have a couple of fired-up people and a couple of fired-up teams tomorrow when we play, and Hope Harris is there. Height goes in. I think with all of what we've seen here today, Tom, Robert Parrish's status is really going to be the crucial thing coming into tomorrow's game.
The surprising thing is that all season long, Parrish has been there for this ball club, and they have played precious few games without him. He is a key player.
Sally draws the foul, and of course, the only game the Celtics lost when they had one of their big people out was when Robert Parrish was injured in game six against Milwaukee. Aaron Day twisted an ankle, but he's in there.
He went down on a drive, and that kind of hurts. And it may not show up till later after the game, but you'll see him limping up the court.
Sally is on the line, and in any event, what we've seen today is the awakening of the Detroit Pistons, a team that really played passive basketball against the Celtics in Boston in the first two, especially in game one when they had a chance to catch the Celtics in their guard down. They didn't, and they've come back with a vengeance here today and are, even though they don't have a tall team size-wise, are playing a physical style, and that's going to be the way they have to play against the Celtics.
The Pistons started the series here today. I don't think they were emotionally ready or had a game plan all set in mind to defeat Boston, but they sure do have an idea how to do it now.
Roberts.
Thanks.
And Rodman can't save it. It's Boston ball. Leading scorers in the game, Bird and McHale each with 17. Day has 15 for Detroit. Dantley has 25 and Thomas 23. Mahorn out of the pack. In the Sally. He's fouled. Isn't it amazing, Tommy, with the problems we've had on the court, Rick Mahorn was not part of any of them.
I think he's trying to change his image out here in Detroit. For years, he was known as one of those bad guys, but out here, he's just been a hustling, aggressive, physical player.
He won the power forward spot after Sidney Green started 69 games this year and then was benched when Mahorn came on strong. And there's Sidney. And on the line now is Sally. Talk about Sally's effectiveness. 8 points and 7 rebounds. Now 9. And here was a guy who was a little skittery in the games in Boston. So was Rodman. And it looks like coming home was the best thing for the two Detroit rookies.
Got a little home cooking yesterday when they got here, and their minds are more familiar with the fans, the pressure, and playing in the Silverdome.
20-point lead for Detroit. Sally rebounds the miss by Day. You want to know where Robert Parrish is? Re-injured his ankle, did not play the second half, and Larry Bird and Bill Laimbeer were ejected early in this fourth period for punching fouls. The rebound, and he's fouled.
Detroit foul with 15. Vinnie Johnson, his fifth.
Johnson commits his fifth foul.
Casey Jones is just coaching his brains out right now, trying to get this Celtic ball club back down to at least 10 points with 3 minutes to go.
Right now, he's got 5:10 on the clock. Vincent Dumars doing a good job on him, and Roberts hits. 110 to 92, and it's an 18-point game.
This is a real fast defensive unit out there for the Celtics. And they can go out and harass people, but the Pistons have some excellent ball handlers.
Vinnie Johnson with 14 off the bench. Ironically, Adrian Dantley has not scored in this second half after getting 25 in the first 24 minutes of the game.
Detroit Fowler, Tim Dennis Rodman is.
Well, the defending champions. It's been a war for them. The list of injuries, although Darren Day is playing with the hurt. Dennis Johnson resting it. This is the way it's been today, but he'll be back tomorrow, and so will the Pistons. And tomorrow, barring an incredible collapse by Detroit against the Celtics bench, as Seasting comes back, the Pistons will have won the game they had to win, the third game. There was really no chance if they had lost this one. This was their season. And now their season extends another day. And Roberts is fouled inside. And 3:30 Eastern time tomorrow will be there. And don't forget Monday's game, which will be game four of the Lakers-Sonics series.
I'm getting here early for tomorrow's game, Dick.
I may sleep here tonight.
But don't forget to call your wife.
I got that message already. The attendance today at the Silverdome, 23,525. The Pistons, in regular season and postseason, have gone over 1 million in home attendance. And I think the only team ever to do that before were the Seattle Sonics in 78.
Celtics tonight must figure out a way to try and take the pace away from the Pistons, particularly Isaiah Thomas. And then Vinnie Johnson did it too in that second quarter.
Sally from Dumars. 114-93.
In the first two games, Dick, the Pistons took the pace of the game away from themselves.
Day was trying to pass it to Kite. Turns it over. Throws it away. Well, the Pistons will win their ninth in a row at home, including regular season and playoffs.
Well, they certainly came out with a vengeance today, and it appeared that they had the game plan in mind for the first couple of games, and even talking to some of the people in the coaching staff, I wasn't quite sure that they had a definite plan in mind how to beat Boston.
Traveling call against Mahorn. And not happy about it.
Well, here's Mahorn, takes it strong to the hoop, and Day just sneaks inside. And when there is one fight, everybody else is looking for retaliation, and they start to become a little paranoid.
Kurt Nymphius, acquired from the Clippers as insurance in case Mahorn had not come back, will come in. Mahorn goes out, 6 points and 12 rebounds. He had a good game one. He's had a good game three.
And Isaiah Thomas in this first half did an absolutely fantastic job. Oh.
Tommy, we just got a report that Don Nelson will not be back with the Milwaukee Bucks. And he's going to have an interview with the Golden State Warriors for the general manager's post at 6 o'clock tonight. He has been sounded out for other coaching jobs, but he is not allowed, according to his contract, to on a non-compete clause, to be a coach or a player personnel director. But a general manager, he might be able to be, although that might be tested as well. But Golden State is willing to, I guess, go through with that test. And Jim Fitzgerald, his mentor in Milwaukee, is the guy out of Golden State who's bringing him out there.
And they had a very amicable relationship, and they're truly best of friends. And that's something that Nelson felt he missed with the current owner, Herb Cole.
Nymphius's foul going in. 3:26 to go. 114-96. And I remember, Tommy, when we talked to him, you specifically, really, a couple of weeks ago in Milwaukee, more than that, he said that I could become a general manager or, barring that, maybe just sit out for a while.
And I was more prone to believe that he would sit out for a couple of years. The rigors of coaching, particularly in the playoffs, like he has done for the last several years, really drain you as a person.
Pistons keep it alive. Nine on the clock. Vinnie Johnson. And the rebound and a loose ball foul. At the conclusion of the game, Tom and I will select the Miller Lite player of the game, and in conjunction with the award, Miller Lite will present a check in the amount of $1,000 to the National Multiple Sclerosis Society in that player's name.
Well, Dennis Rodman will be shooting the free throw, I think, as he came flying out of the pack.
Foul is on Kite.
A try for the rebound. Oh, Dennis better just take his time on these free throws, or he is going to work himself into a real fit about taking foul shots.
One for four from the line for Rodman. Henry. For three. He's got it. 3 points for Connor Henry. And it's 115-99. That much time remaining in the fourth. The Pistons getting back in the series after losing the first two in Boston.
I'm very impressed with the way Isaiah Thomas really came out. Didn't get emotionally out of control. Dished it off. Got everybody involved. That got their heads involved. The crowd responded to it. And boy, Boston just succumbed to all that pressure.
Sally, 14 points and 8 rebounds. Celtics using their bench down the stretch all the way and hoping that they'll have their five back tomorrow.
Look to northwest.
Even in towns like Bemidji, Minnesota, you'll find the red tail of Northwest. Northwest flies to over 200 cities all across America, all the way to London, to 19 countries on three continents, to Tokyo, our gateway to Asia. Nobody flies from more of the U.S. to more of the world than Northwest.
Look to us, Northwest.
Here's news of big value on Ford's big pickup. Right now, get 3.9% financing or $600 cash back. Add a special option package and save up to $2,397 on select F-Series pickups. See your Ford dealers soon.
What a help.
Yeah, get the brakes done?
Uh-huh.
You might have sized them?
I didn't think it mattered.
Didn't matter? Halfway up the Himalayas and it didn't matter?
Might have sized your brakes and get it right the first time.
Uno, dos! One, two, tres, cuatro.
This is one of California Cooper's original testing facilities.
Watch it now, watch it, watch it!
Today, that blend has been perfected. But hey, test it anyway. California Cooper, the real stuff.
Bobby Watkins has a one-stroke lead in the third round, and you'll see action coming up next on CBS. In a close contest at the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic. Tommy, what about the Pistons tomorrow? We talked a lot about the Celtics and their health and what they have to do. What about Detroit?
I would think that they should not go out and celebrate tonight. That's because they've won one game at home. That's kind of expected in the playoffs. And I think Boston might have hoped to have won one here. Probably maybe the first, where perhaps the Pistons didn't have their heads together after the two losses in Boston. But they must again reassert themselves and play a strong pace game, an effort game, and a controlling emotion type of game. And Boston is going to be sky high because of the fight in tomorrow's game. I think the first half is going to be very important.
Of course, I think Lane Beer and the Pistons aren't necessarily going to be quiet as a result of the fight either.
Nope, I don't think they will, but it is one of those things that when you're at home, when you get in a fight, the fans are with you. When you're on the road, they're against you.
Well, you're right about Detroit needing the win tomorrow after getting this one, because they've lost 16 in a row at Boston Garden. So they've got to hope they win their home games, and they've got to somehow win one in Boston if they hope to win this series. Vincent with a three-pointer has 18. That's a career high in the regular season and the playoff for Sam Vincent. So Detroit really needs to win their games at home and then hope to break the string on the road.
They've got to win one in Boston. The Celtics were hoping to win one here. If it was the third, their best chance was to win this particular ball game, but it didn't happen. But they're experienced enough to know that there are still two other games here at Pontiac. If it goes that far.
Well, the Pistons were able to hold on to their second half lead, even though they did not push the ball up the way they did in the first half.
But that pacing in the second half here might have really been able to take a lot of the legs away for tomorrow's ball game for the Celtics. I think it might have been a big advantage.
Well, except they had the reserves in.
Now they're playing for this game too, but there's a little thinking ahead perhaps.
I guess all of this is a great preamble to tomorrow's fourth game.
Well, you know the emotions. I don't think the Pistons were emotionally into the first two games in a proper way, but they sure are now.
Chuck Nevitt gets off the bench, Tommy. 7-5. Chuck Nevitt. He was with the Lakers in the 85 season. He's on the bench in the finals of the 85 campaign, so he's been there for the big games, at least there.
You know, his size, 7'6". He gets on an elevator to people, say, how's the weather up there? He says, all I know is I get rained on first.
Henry for three. And Rodman is fouled. Greg Kite, and he's fouled out. Kite with his sixth foul. 119-104. And the worst Celtic playoff loss since the Lakers did a number on them in game three a couple of years ago. Tony Campbell comes in for the Pistons. Former number one draft pick from Ohio State. And he's really in a disappearing act in time and shooting and everything, Campbell. Dumars goes out.
I happen to think Tony Campbell is an exceptional offensive player that up front, but when they got Adrian Dantley, his minutes went down dramatically, and then Rodman really moved the feet better on defense, and he lost his time.
Dantley with 25. Laimbeer 18. Thomas 23. Dumars 15 and Sally 14. Vinny Johnson 14 points.
No basket.
No basket.
Offensive foul on Boston's number one.
And the offensive foul on Sam Vincent. 120-104. A lot of points by the Pistons today. They had 73 at the half. Under a minute to go. Tony Campbell, who's got to be rusty, short. And Henry overthrows Seastate. Larry Bird ejected with Bill Laimbeer and a punching foul early in the fourth period. Robert Parrish, question of his ankle will be the key question when we start tomorrow.
Celtics will really have a world of trouble if Parrish is not able to participate in tomorrow's game or even through the rest of the series.
How is Nevitt? Icing on the cake for the crowd here of 23,000 plus. Day. A presence. This is it. You'll hear the crowd. Pistons win it. 122-104. And the series is now 2-1. Still in favor of the Boston Celtics.
Mobil 1 synthetic motor oil. No matter what you drive or how you drive, or where you drive, or what conditions you drive under. With Mobil synthetic oil technology, there's no finer engine protection anywhere. Save up to $3 on Mobil oils and up to $19 on all these products at participating Mobil stations and leading retailers.
They're here. They're scary. Strange, alien creatures. Run for cover. Run for safety. Run for your light. Run to wherever Miller Lite is sold and look for this special display. Because in specially marked cases of Miller Lite, there's a chance to be an instant winner of up to $100,000. But hurry, because they drink Miller Lite too, and the end is near.
We're doomed.
Sweepstakes ends June 30th, 1987.
In North Carolina, Honda lawnmowers are assembled from the wheels up. Then the final critical step, the Clara Johnson test. If Clara pulls and it starts, it's a Honda.
Ship it.
Your face takes enough abuse, so Gillette introduces the new Good News Plus disposable. Its Luber Smooth Strip is designed to reduce irritation, so shaving feels so good. New Good News Plus.
And our Miller Lite player of the game is Adrian Dantley, who scored 25 points on great shooting today. All of his points came in the first half when the game was decided today. And Miller is proud to present a check for $1,000 to the Multiple Sclerosis Society on behalf of Adrian Dantley. Sam Vincent led the Celtics, believe it or not, with a career-high 18 points. Detroit had six players in double figures today.
What harm can a little water do? Ordinary paint can't withstand the sneaking, creeping effects of water.
in time. That's why there's Rust-Oleum. We put our own exclusive ingredients in for one simple reason, to keep moisture out. So if it's going to get wet, get Rust-Oleum.
Two out of three Indy drivers rely on STP oil treatment. Because when it comes down to it, STP adds extra lubrication to reduce engine wear in whatever you drive.
STP is the racer's edge.
Here's some real value news from Ford. Right now, get 3.9% financing on the award-winning Taurus for $500 cash back. Add a special option package and save up to $1,050. Savings are available on other Ford cars, too. See your Ford dealer soon.
Once you look through a Minolta Maxim, you'll never see life the same way again. Maxim, the world's first SLR with built-in autofocus. 26 autofocus lenses capture the action as only you see it. Minolta Maxim, let your creativity come to life. The Maxim system, all the things you'll do.
Only you and the mind of Minolta.
The Pistons come back at home and now trail 2-1. So for Tom Heinsohn and Pat O'Brien, I'm Dick Stockton saying so long from the Pontiac Silverdome in Pontiac, where the final score, the Pistons 122, the Celtics 104. Join us tomorrow for game 4 of this Eastern Conference Final between the Celtics and the Pistons. Coming up next, third round coverage of the Georgia Pacific Atlanta Golf Classic. CBS is a presentation of CBS Sports.
United can show you the old Hawaii where time takes a rest. And you can become yourself again. So come become Hawaii with the airline that's been her friend for nearly 40 years. United.
Wednesday on The Equalizer.
I'm worried about my dad. I think he's in a lot of trouble.
Can McCall pull the plug on nuclear theft?
Plutonium.
Time's up Wednesday.
This is CBS.
You touch a button and reach out across time and space. A miracle. To all of you who trusted us when we asked you to make the right choice, AT&T makes a promise. The miracle we created to serve you continues.
In the months to come, we'd like to take you behind the button, into the most intelligent long-distance network on Earth, to show you how our scientists compress the intelligence of this into this, to change the speed and ease with which the world communicates forever, to see how we improve sound quality by turning it into millions of digital signals,
or create lightning in a laboratory to test our equipment, the equipment you depend on before nature does.
Because AT&T believes that behind the wonder of every technology, you must hear the human heart.
I'm fine, Mom. Yeah, the storm's over.
We're reaching further to bring your world closer. AT&T, the right choice.
They called for it on the Marienplatz in Munich.